Good evening, everyone, and we welcome you to the campus of May River High School, where tonight WHHI Sports presents the Cross County Bowl with the May River Sharks hosting the Beaufort Eagles. I'm Chris Trembley, joined by Bob Stevens and Jeff Shane. And Bob, let's start out talking about the host team, a team that comes at you with a whole lot of running, and they do it well.
They do. They're playing awfully good football right now. They are undefeated, something obviously they haven't had any experience with doing before, coming off the first two losing seasons. So they're playing with a whole lot of momentum, a momentum that may have been jarred just a little bit by the storm in the week that kind of interrupted practice and preparations, but they've stayed pretty healthy. They keep adding little things. They keep just getting a little bit better. This may be the best team in the Lowcountry.
The two offensive weapons, Ahmad Green, the quarterback, and Brandon Morales, talk about them a little bit.
Well, we could see Brandon Morales get over 1,000 yards for the season in this game. That's terrific. Ahmad Green hasn't had to throw the football. We forget that he's still just a sophomore, and yet he continues to lead this team. They haven't had to play a lot in the last three games. They've been all blowouts. They've won them by an average of something like 42-8. So they've been able to stay rested. They're not beat up at all. I think when the lights go on, they're going to be ready to go. They are concerned, though, about a Beaufort team that's bigger than they are, and they haven't really faced that against so far this year.
Let's talk about that Beaufort team. Jeff, a team that last week obviously didn't perform the way they wanted to. On offense, they really had a tough time getting going.
Yeah, they really did against a very strong and fast Bluffton defensive front, and they're, as much as they want to start throwing the ball, they are still a run first offense. And James Dagan, for the most part, was just bottled up. He was hurt for a little bit in the first quarter, didn't come back until the second quarter, was able to break one later on, but just never really got anything rolling, and by the time Dagan did get a little bit of momentum, they were way behind.
Jeffrey Smith was under constant pressure last week, their quarterback. They brought in Tyler Haley a little bit, the freshman, but regardless, they just didn't have any time.
No, and that's where they're going to have to be especially worried against the May River defense. With those four outstanding linebackers, they're going to bring pressure from one side, the other side, all sides. All four of those May River linebackers have at least 60 tackles, and it was the outside linebackers of Bluffton that really created the most problem for Beaufort last week.
We're hoping to see linebacker Will Kelly this week. When you talk about their defense, he's old school football. He's a hard-knocking kid that just wants a piece of the action on every play.
Absolutely. He is a tackling machine. He is the guy that leads that defense, not only statistically, but is their heart and soul. And when he performs well, it seems like everybody else comes around him and raises their game. And I can see why May River would be a little bit a concern, because if they don't block Will Kelly, Will Kelly will create chaos.
This should be a good one tonight. May River comes in at 6-0, Beaufort at 2-4. When we come back, we're going to talk to the coaches right after this.
Hilton Head Island's pristine beaches are one reason the area has boomed over the past 50 years, and Hilton Head Exterminators was there in the beginning. We covered the island, protecting homes and businesses as the island's first pest control company. Since then, we've expanded to protect homes and businesses beyond the island into Bluffton and the surrounding Lowcountry. Everywhere you look, you'll see one of our vehicles. Hilton Head Exterminators, here in the beginning, and we're still here, growing along with the communities we protect.
The life lessons that I learned playing football are priceless and started much earlier than my NFL career. As part of a team, I learned accountability, discipline, and the value of hard work. But the most important lesson is safety. Keep your kids safe during practice and during the game. Educate yourself and your kids. Learn the symptoms of concussions and how to prevent them. Everything starts with fundamentals, but remember, safety is first. For more information, visit peacockloves.com.
I'm a first-generation student. I needed a career change. I decided to go back to school, to TCL. I thought that returning to school would be more difficult, but the multiple financial aid opportunities, the support and encouragement from the staff and faculty was more than I could have ever expected. I'm a second-year radiologic technology student. I'm pursuing a career in X-ray. My name is Kelly, and I made it happen, no matter what.
And we welcome in Beaufort offensive coordinator Bryce Liebrand. Your first year here with the Eagles. Tell us a little bit about how it's going.
It's going all right. You know, it's we got a great group of kids. We're still learning the system and still trying to figure out, you know, how to do things the way we want it done. But we're changing the culture, you know, and that's what we're trying to do. And, you know, I think the whole staff has done a really good job of trying to facilitate that.
Last week against Bluffton, things offensively didn't go quite as you were looking for. What did you address this week?
You know, just getting back to basics and trying to get back to doing what we do. And, you know, more on my part, just us doing what we do and not trying to out-scheme anybody or anything like that. Just playing ball and playing tough, fast, and physical for 48 minutes.
Having to work on things this week, obviously we had a short practice week because of the hurricane. What were you able to get done?
You know, we had two really solid days of practice, you know, Monday and Tuesday. Tuesday was a little bit wet, but I thought our kids handled it really well. I think our coaches did a really good job with it. So, you know, as much as you can get done in 2 days, we got done in 2 days. So we felt good about what we got done in those couple days.
Let's talk about some players on your team. Obviously, last week against Bluffton, we saw Jeffrey Smith at quarterback for most of the game. But we did see a freshman, Tyler Haley, who came in, and we saw that he's got a little bit of a gun. Any chance we're going to see him a little bit tonight?
Yeah, you'll see both of them tonight. You know, everything rotates around Jeffrey, you know, offensively and defensively. He's done such a great job. He's been a four-year starter for us. So, you know, our kids look to him to see, you know, how we need to go. You know, we feel like Tyler does a lot of really good things to be a kid his age. So he's a kid that you'll see some tonight, you know, and we'll kind of ride the hot hand. But Jeffrey's a leader of the football team.
Let's jump over to defense. You have a force to be reckoned with there in Will Kelly on the defense. We saw it last week against Bluffton. Talk to us about him a little bit.
Oh, he's an old-school football player. He's a downhill kid. He plays really hard. I think he really loves football. He's a little dinged up, so you might not see him tonight. But he's the kind of kid you want on the football team, especially at that middle linebacker position.
Bryce, thanks so much for spending some time with us. Best of luck tonight.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
When we come back, we'll have May River coach Rodney Summers right after this pregame timeout.
Home is that magical spot where weekends happen. It's tea parties and superheroes. It's one more bedtime story. It's your first, your last, and everything in between. Home is where you belong. We get it. Whether it's your first home, your next home, or your dream home, we want to build you the very best home for your life. Let us help you get started. VillageParkHomes.com. Close to everything, far from ordinary.
Beam Graphics Printing Company. We specialize in custom printing, screen printing, embroidery, engraving, trophies, team uniforms, business uniforms, signs and banners, and much more. We are conveniently located in the heart of Bluffton at 12 Johnston Way across from the post office. For all your printing needs, call the locals at Beam Graphics, 843-837-9663. You can also check us out online at beamgraphics.com and like us on Facebook for specials and design ideas.
Have you been hurt on the job, injured in a car accident, experiencing marital difficulties? Nairt and Dubois are attorneys located on the south end of Hilton Head Island. With their extensive experience and knowledge of the law, they can help you on your legal matter. Nairt and Dubois offer free initial consultation. So whether you have been hurt on the job, injured in a car accident, or experiencing marital difficulties, call the attorneys of Nairt and Dubois now to schedule an appointment to learn about your legal rights.
Talking to the head coach of May River, all dressed in, got his black and white on, got his shark stuff on, he's ready to go. Right in the middle of region play, you stick a non-region game in against a team that's going to be a rival forever. What's that do to the guys, and what's that do for preparation?
You know, it's not ideal. Obviously, when you're in region play and then you go and play a non-region opponent, especially as tough as a Beaufort team and classification above us. But, you know, we were looking at the schedule and trying to figure out some games, and we had a hole and we couldn't get things filled, so called them up, and we were able to work it out to get this weekend, and storm came and everything, but we're still going to get it in tonight. And so, you know, it's just one of those things, and hopefully our guys are prepared.
What'd you lose preparation-wise because of the storm?
You know, we lost Wednesday. Okay. The district didn't let us do anything after school, so the kids had to go home. We met with them before they left and told them, hey, look, you know, stay safe. Everybody's going to be out. If we can get back in school Friday, we're planning on playing. So don't go on a hurricane is what I told them.
Your team has been remarkably healthy this year, knock on wood, and that has allowed you to continue to advance. Are you putting new things in every week? Are we starting to see a little more and a little more?
I mean,
thinking about playing.
Yeah, we're trying to. I mean, we've got things we've held back and not, you know, shown, and some things. But you also got to worry about sometimes you put things in and something's got to come out, you know, and because they can't hold but so much. Yeah. And so we take it slow and we make sure that we evaluate them in practice and see what they can retain and what they can do well, and hopefully those are the things that we'll be able to execute and on Friday night.
We watched you guys a lot early in the season. We haven't seen you in the last couple of 3 weeks. Three pretty easy wins. Is the team where you want them to be through all of that, or do you wish they'd have been tighter games and you had
You know, win's a win, you know. I like
go.
To say, but no, we do want, you know, this is one of the games that we felt like is once we got to this point, and we got through you know, Marion, we got through Ridgeland, and we're 6-0, and we kind of weren't really tested. This is going to be a test. This is going to test our team and see where we are physically, mentally.
What do you worry about happening from them?
They're so well up front. You know, they're big guys. We haven't seen a defensive line or a defensive front like them. So that's going to test our offense and our offensive line.
All right. Should be a whole lot of fun. Rodney Summers, May River. We're back with the kickoff and the national anthem and all that stuff when we continue right here on WHHI.
At Georgia Southern University, we're setting the standard for higher education in Southeast Georgia on three exciting campuses in Savannah, Statesboro, and Hinesville. We're offering more opportunities for hands-on learning, more ways to help our students find a career, and more economic impact on our region. At Georgia Southern University, discover more, connect more, be more. Florida and South Carolina residents get in-state tuition at our Armstrong and Liberty campuses.
Turbyville Insurance Agency has you covered in Beaufort, Bluffton, and throughout the Lowcountry. We are your independent insurance agency who will give you choices for peace of mind on your home, auto, business, life, health, and retirement plans by finding the best combination of price, coverage, and service. At Turbyville Insurance, we'll keep up with your changing insurance needs and are committed to customer satisfaction. Call us today and experience the Turbyville difference.
Hilton Head PSD offers convenient and secure online billing. Just have your PSD bill handy and click on the online bill payment button at hhpsd.com. You'll be guided through the steps to establish your online billing account. Their payment options allow you to set up recurring credit card payments, you can view your consumption history, and more. Remember to have your PSD bill handy when you visit hhpsd.com to get started. Hilton Head PSD, we're always working for you.
Our Palmetto Electric Cooperative, your Touchstone Energy Partner.
Let's take a moment to honor America with the playing of the national anthem, proudly sponsored by OT Decor. Visit otdecor.com to transform your home into your American dream. Thank you. are ready for the opening kickoff here in the Cross County Bowl. Chris Tremblay along with Bob Stevens. Jeff Shane will be on the sideline, and immediately May River takes the kickoff and gets a good return. That's number 18, Jonathan Gaston, who gets them some pretty good yardage right out of the gates, and they're going to start with a short field.
Sharks off to a terrific start on the little pooch kickoff. And again, one of the up men, Gaston, brings it back across the 50 all the way to the 42 of Beaufort. That's where the Sharks will tee it up.
Ahmad Green in the shotgun, the sophomore quarterback. He's been a weapon on the ground as much as up in the air. Brandon Morales, who we should see carry the ball quite frequently tonight, takes it forward for a couple.
Averages 7 yards a carry on the season. He's run for over 900. We could see him break the 1,000-yard barrier tonight.
Needs 95 tonight.
Good math by you.
Yeah. Second and four now. Ball's on the ground, and immediately Buford gets it. Number 5, Jeffrey Smith, the quarterback on offense. He's right on the ball. And he's going to get the ball.
Boy, Big Mo takes a huge turn very early on. Jeffrey Smith pouncing on the loose ball. The free safety up on the line, defending against May River's great vaunted rushing attack. Pounces on the loose football, and now he'll turn around and play quarterback.
And that's one of the things we're probably going to need to see out of May River tonight for them to establish the run the way they like, is they're going to have to show that they can also do a little something in the air. Smith now on first down, hands it off immediately to James Dagan, who was the main point producer for Buford last week. Did it on a longer run and a 91-yard kickoff return.
Slowed down by Ridge Dow and then pulled down from there. Loss of yardage, again, good penetration. May River taking a page out of the Bluffton playbook defensively and putting pressure on from the outside on that very first play.
And we're going to have an offsides on May River, it appears. James Waldrop.
Coachman on the defense. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Referee tonight is James Waldrop. The umpire, Jeff Hennessy. The linesman, Olin Bonner. The line judge is J.C. Booker. And Michael McGarry is the back judge. Second and 5 now. Smith takes it, looks to go to the air, and airs it out down the right sideline, and he's got a man right there. He was looking for number 87, Matt Haley. That ball's incomplete. We'll bring up third down. Let's go to Jeff Shane on the sideline.
Guys, it's been a very tough week over at the Buford football program. Coach Devontae Holloman is not here tonight. He is up in Charlotte after the sudden passing of his youngest sister. And this was something that happened late last week that was just starting to develop when the Eagles were taking on Bluffton High last week. He has spent most of the week out of town. Like I say, he's up in Charlotte. Her services are tomorrow, so he is not anywhere close to the stadium tonight. That's why we were talking to offensive coordinator Bryce Liebrand before the game. So tough week there. And then also, we learned after the open that their all Lowcountry linebacker, Will Kelly, is not in uniform tonight. He did not complete concussion protocol before the game, so he is sitting out. He's going to have to go through another week of concussion protocol. Brandon Bowersox is taking his place at linebacker, and they're trying to plug in guys along the defensive front. Back to you guys.
Thank you for that, Jeff. Our thoughts and prayers are certainly with head coach Devontae Holloman and his family. And we're certainly thinking of him. Jeff's sideline report is brought to you by Turbyville, your local independent insurance agency that has you covered throughout the Low Country. Buford had to punt on fourth down. May River has the ball back, and they start from their own 22. Ball immediately goes to Brandon Morales, who picks up a couple.
Gets a great block from Kalen Big Man Ferguson, the left guard who was pulling behind Gabe Long, the center.
I like that name, Big Man. I want to run behind Big Man.
Absolutely. 280-pound junior, number 69.
Second and four now. Green takes it. Morales has it again, and he's going to get a first down. And so far, the recipe has been give it to Brandon Morales and see what he can do, and he's done okay. May River took the opening kickoff, had a short field on their second play from scrimmage. They turned it over. Buford was three and out, and that's where we are right now. Green is going to keep it himself this time. Runs on the right side, picks up about three or four.
Desmond Gaylard, a senior cornerback, helping on the tackle, along with outside linebacker George Williams.
When you look at the May River running attack, Brandon Morales comes in averaging 7 yards a carry. Ahmad Green's averaging 7.2 yards a carry. Travis Polite Grant, who we'll see carry it some tonight, is averaging 9 yards a carry. And there goes the pitch to Morales around the left side, and he's got some room. And Morales gets another first down, and he's well into Buford Eagle territory.
Brandon Morales on his way to 1,000 yards. He's about 25 input.
Easily.
We'll kind of keep an eye on that as the game continues.
Technical College of the Lowcountry. Make it happen no matter what. That's Technical College of the Lowcountry. First and 10 now from the Buford 41. Morales gets it again. This time he finds the running a little harder going, picks up about three.
That offensive line for May River, Gabe Long, the senior center co-captain. The left guard is Big Man Ferguson, Joseph Whitaker, the left tackle. Connor Kovacs plays right guard, Will Wilson, the right tackle. They start three seniors, a junior and a sophomore across that offensive line that has been terrific for most of the season.
Second and eight now, about 8:15 left in the first quarter of the Cross County Bowl here. Morales gets it, and he's got another first down, and he just keeps on going, and he's down inside the 30-yard line, and May River is on the move.
Defensive tackle Jeff Radcliffe coming from behind the play to make the tackle.
Mike Rickenbaugh Chevrolet, before you buy, give us a try.
43 Kendrick Williams, also a part of the defense for Buford.
Ahmad Green looking in, getting some signals.
You heard Rodney Summers in the pregame tell us that this is something May River is challenging itself with, trying to run against a big Buford front line.
Green takes it, Morales goes right up the middle. He's got some room to run, and he'll come up a couple yards short of the first down. May River comes into this one 6-0, Buford at 3-4. In our pregame introduction, I denied Buford a victory, so I apologize, Eagle fans. They are 3-4, not 2-4.
But the three were long enough ago, you might have forgotten one of them.
Very good point.
They won their first three, they've lost their last four. This one doesn't matter in the big scheme of things.
Green wanted to pitch it, then decided to keep it. And he'll be close to the first down, depends on how they mark it. The May River fans showing their true colors tonight with their shark hats. I like them.
You stole one.
I did get one. We'll have to see if I put it on later.
If they win, you should vow to wear it during
the post-game show. Okay. You got it. It's a deal. Green hands it to Morales. Morales gets tripped up, but he does get inside the 25. And that will be a first down.
William Winburn making the tackle. He might get to 1,000 in this first quarter. Needed 95 yards, had 130 carries this year, has scored 12 touchdowns on the ground, has two more on the only two passes he's caught this season, both for touchdowns.
Green takes it, he's going to keep it, try the right side, and he runs into a little bump, but he just keeps on going, and now they sneak down inside the 10-yard line. Village Park Homes is your true hometown builder. They're close to everything, but far from ordinary.
Ahmad Green has run the ball a whole lot more times than he has thrown it this year.
May River keeps it on the ground. Morales finds the going a little tougher that time. Picks up maybe one.
Defensive play there made by junior George Williams. If you missed our game last week, great story about George, the junior linebacker, was shot during an incident this summer, has been recovering from that, and football has been his refuge, has really, according to Devontae Holloman, turned his life around.
Green's gonna go to the air for the first time tonight, and he's got a man out there, and that's Jack Hegan. The last time we had May River on, he was Mr. Touchdown, because half of the catches he's had through the season were for touchdowns. He's got, that was his 13th catch of the year, but he already has four touchdowns.
His ratio's gone to pieces.
Yeah, how about it?
Still got four.
Third and four now, Morales takes it, and there's nothing happening up the middle. And that'll bring up fourth down, and we'll see what May River does. Or is that third down? I'm sorry, it'll bring up third down. Or a second and goal. We seem to have lost track there, my bad.
One of those things, the pass got him the first down. Second and goal from the six.
There we go, from there. Thank you, let's do that. I like it. Green takes it, hands it to Morales, and he gets nothing.
Really good penetration by number 40, Kaye Little, the senior. He's the one who is having to take Will Kelly's place at linebacker, or actually at defensive end, as they've moved Bowersox back to linebacker. But Kaye Little
awfully big shoes to fill.
Yeah, he's been asked to rise to the occasion, and so far has. That's about his third tackle during this drive.
Turbyville Insurance is your local independent insurance agency that has you covered throughout the Lowcountry. That's Turbyville Insurance. Green takes it, throws to the right side, looking for Hegan. And now that'll bring up fourth down.
Interesting decision to make here for May River. They've marched the ball between the 20s very well, have stalled down inside the 10. They have three different place kickers. So even if they decide to go for the field goal, which it looks like they're going to do, they've got a decision to make as to who's going to do it. It looks like it's going to be Bryce Summers.
Yep. Summers.
So Summers is in to give it a try here from 25 yards out. Snap is down, kick is up, kick is no good, it's off to the right. So the Beaufort Eagles dodge one there, and they'll take over right where May River was snapping from.
You see Jeffrey Smith might just play every down tonight. He is the quarterback, he's the free safety. He was in on special teams there.
OT Decor offers unique lighting designs. Visit their website, otdecor.com, to find the perfect accent to your home. We have a timeout, let's go to a Village Park Homes timeout.
Home is that magical spot where weekends happen. It's tea parties and superheroes. It's one more bedtime story. It's your first, your last, and everything in between. Home is where you belong. We get it. Whether it's your first home, your next home, or your dream home, we want to build you the very best home for your life. Let us help you get started. VillageParkHomes.com. Close to everything, far from ordinary.
The life lessons that I learned playing football are priceless and started much earlier than my NFL career. As part of a team, I learned accountability, discipline, and the value of hard work. But the most important lesson is safety. Keep your kids safe during practice and during the game. Educate yourself and your kids. Learn the symptoms of concussions and how to prevent them. Everything starts with fundamentals, but remember, safety is first. For more information, visit peacockloves.com.
Elite Physical Therapy has enjoyed being your physical therapy provider for the past 10 years. They focus their attention individually, with each and every patient, providing a hands-on approach to accelerate your recovery so you can get back to the active lifestyle to which you're accustomed. At Elite Physical Therapy, you'll be treated by the same licensed physical therapist every session to work towards goals you set together. Take control of your health care and choose the best in physical therapy.
So as we come back, Beaufort on first down. Jeffrey Smith was back to pass, but he's decided to run it. And a good choice on his part is he's got some room, and Jeffrey Smith just keeps on going. He gets down inside the 35-yard line of May River, and we have a flag, and it very well could be a face mask. And that'll tack on even more. So Jeffrey Smith looking to pass, decides to run it, and a good choice on his behalf, and he picks up the better part of about 50 yards. Let's see what James Waldrop has to say.
We got a personal foul, horse collar, on the defense. It's a 15-yard penalty, first down.
And what a big play, a horse collar penalty, and Beaufort moves even closer. And just like that, when it looked like May River might go in, now Buford's threatening.
Well, they flipped the field. They were down inside their own 10-yard line. Now they're inside the May River 20.
So we've got first and 10 now from about the 19. Smith takes it, gives it to Dagan up the middle. Dagan picks up maybe two.
Michael Ludwig, defensive end. Getting off that pile, Caleb Folk, one of those four linebackers from May River that we talked about in the pregame that all have more than 65 tackles in the first six games. Each one of those four.
Those are some busy guys.
Oh.
Second and eight now. Smith looks over to the sideline. They might be switching things up. Matthew Haley lined up wide left. And we might have had a little movement there on Beaufort a little early on. Looks like a false start.
Before the snap, delay on the offense. It's a 5-yard penalty, still second down.
So we have a delay of game, but still backs them up five. Bring up second and 13. Bet that doesn't happen twice in a row. Smith gets the ball. He's going to try to run again, it looks like, but he decides to throw it and comes up a little short there, looking for Reed Rochelle, who will be one of his popular targets tonight.
Still a good job by Smith in evading the rush. Headed for the line of scrimmage, then he's got the run pass option. Went ahead and tried to throw it down the field, but just a little bit low.
Elite Physical Therapy, be an advocate for your health care. You have a choice. Choose the best. Elite Physical Therapy.
Also a pink out tonight for May River in honor of Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Third and 13 now. Smith takes it, fakes it there. Morales, and he throws across, or to Amari Morris, throws it across the middle, incomplete, and that'll bring up fourth down. Once again, Reed Rochelle was the intended target.
But once again, Stefan Gadsden, actually the closest to the ball, the sophomore defensive back.
It'll bring up a fourth down.
So fourth down.
Fourth and 13, the field goal attempt would be about close to 40 yards.
Nope,
they're going for it. Look for Smith to air this one out. And he's going to try to run for it. He's got some room, and he's got a first down. So Jeffrey Smith, looking to find a target on fourth and 13, decides to pull up and do it all himself, and they're inside the 10-yard line now.
Watch Amore Morris make a great block. They kept the running back in. He blocked Ridge Dow and gave Jeffrey Smith some escape room, gave him a chance to get out from the backfield. Again, they were trying to pinch in from the corners and pen Jeffrey Smith back in there, but a great block by Amore Morris allowed Smith to get free.
First and goal from the 6-yard line. Amari Morris tries the right side, picks up a couple. Looks like he got down to about the 4-yard line. A whole bunch of sharks there to bring him down. And Buford's threatening. Charles Sampson, his group from Charter One Realty, they sponsor the MVP award at the end of the game. Don't forget to stick around for that. Second and goal now from just inside the 5. We're scoreless here in the Cross County Bowl. Ball goes up the middle to Morris and he doesn't get anything.
Rod Grant, the senior co-captain, 44, in on the tackle. He had 46 of them in 6 games coming into this one, including 9 tackles for a loss. Looks like they might have lost a yard there. Back at the 5, third and goal now for Buford.
Matthew Haley, the big target, lines up wide to the right. Smith looking that way. He might have to try to run it himself again, and he goes one way and he's gonna cut back the other, throws it all the way across the field to a wide open Reed Rochelle, just a little above his head, and that'll bring up 4th down. So Jeffrey Smith very alertly sees a target on the far corner of the field, just overshoots him a bit. And we have a flag down. And let's see what James Waldrop has to say.
Looks like he might be signaling a defensive hold against May River, which would give new life to the Eagles.
Play. We got an illegal block in the back on the defense. So half the distance to the goal line. Replay 3rd down.
Okay, so that'll take the ball down to about the 2.5-yard line. Jeffrey Smith will have another opportunity to punch it in here.
You'd like to see him get the chance to finish it off. He's done all the work.
Very
so
true.
Far, as far as carrying the mail.
James Dagan in the backfield with him. Dagan had both scores for Buford last week. Smith takes it, gives it right to Dagan, who tries the left side, and he gets in for a TCL touchdown, and Buford strikes first here in the Cross County Bowl. So James Dagan from 2.5 yards out gets Bluffton on the board.
Dagan finishes off the work that Jeffrey Smith began with his 70-yard run from out of their own end, and then the first down and drive saving run on 4th down. Dagan finishes it off, gets in the end zone. Eagles up 6-0.
And Peyton Langford's kick is good. And as we go to break, Buford leads it 7-0. We'll be back right after this.
Hilton Head Island's pristine beaches are one reason the area has boomed over the past 50 years. And Hilton Head Exterminators was there in the beginning. We covered the island, protecting homes and businesses as the island's first pest control company. Since then, we've expanded to protect homes and businesses beyond the island into Bluffton and the surrounding Lowcountry. Everywhere you look, you'll see one of our vehicles. Hilton Head Exterminators, here in the beginning, and we're still here, growing along with the communities we protect.
Looking for a unique lighting fixture that'll have everyone talking? Check out OT Decor. We have thousands of lighting fixtures that are perfect complements to your house. We carry Kichler, Monte Carlo, Murray Feist, Savoy House, Siegel, and more. Visit our website at otdecor.com to find the perfect accent for your home. Or stop by our showroom and visit with our experienced professionals for a personal touch. While you're here, check out our custom cabinets and vanities.
And the kick is in the air. Short kick taken on the 30-yard line. They get it out to about the 40-yard line, and that's where May River will start. So with 1:23 left here in the first quarter, James Dagan, who did all the scoring for the Buford Eagles last week, takes it in from just over 2 yards out, gets the Eagles on the board first. Really important for them to establish something early and get into this one, because they really weren't able to pass much last week, and catch up isn't their game.
No, that it has always been Beaufort football. Run the ball well, throw when you have to. And to
Green
get
back
lead,
to pass,
huge.
And on his first pass, it's deflected up in the air.
Kaye Little, number 40. The guy who is sort of trying to fill the shoes of Will Kelly. He's not playing the same position. They've moved Brendan Bowersox back to linebacker. But on the roster and in the lineup, it's Little, number 40, at defensive end. And he made the great play there, tipping the ball.
That'll bring up second and 10. Green throws it again. And I'm not so sure if the intended receiver was Jack Hegan. But that also falls incomplete, and just like that, two downs, two incomplete passes, and May River's already looking at third and 10 with 1:10 left here in the first quarter of the Cross County Bowl. Hilton Head Exterminators, keeping Lowcountry homes and businesses bug-free for nearly 50 years. HiltonHeadExterminators.com. Greenback passing for the third play in a row, looking for a target, throws it off to the right side to Morales, who has a little bit of room. Maybe faked himself out a little bit. Falls about 5 yards short of the first down as we go to under a minute here in the first quarter, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Boy, credit the May River offensive line, though, for giving Ahmad Green all the time in the world to scan the field and pick out a receiver. Certainly, Morales was not his first choice. He ended up being about the only choice. Fourth down.
And as they break, Terry Fields back to punt. Fields gets a good snap, gives it a good end over again kick that takes a May River bounce, and it's going way down deep into their territory, down inside the 1 yard line, it looks like. And Beaufort will have 99 yards to go to make something happen.
They went better than 90 with their last drive. They're gonna have to go all the way with this one. What a great kick. Terry Fields is such a Swiss Army knife for them. Plays safety on defense, can play wide receiver, runs the ball on occasion, and he's a left-footed punter, which coaches love these days because they get the opposite spin on the ball. And he just laid that wedge down inside the 1 yard line.
Well done by Terry Fields. Beaufort now takes over at their own one. They lead it 7-0. Tyler Haley is in at quarterback now, the freshman who saw some action last week against Bluffton. And that play actually went backwards by about half a yard. And with that play, that'll take us to the end of the first quarter. So as we go to break, the Beaufort Eagles lead May River here in the Cross County Bowl 7-0. We'll be back right after this.
The best bargains in the Lowcountry are at the Salvation Army Family Thrift Store in Beaufort. Stop in and see the selection and feel good knowing all items in the store are donated and all profits from them stay local to help families in need. There's 50% off colored tagged items every day, and you can also help by donating clothing, furniture, and other items in good, clean condition. All donations to the Salvation Army are tax deductible. Visit the Salvation Army Family Thrift Store at 164 Robert Smalls Parkway in Beaufort.
Hilton Head Island's pristine beaches are one reason the area has boomed over the past 50 years, and Hilton Head Exterminators was there in the beginning. We covered the island, protecting homes and businesses as the island's first pest control company. Since then, we've expanded to protect homes and businesses beyond the island into Bluffton and the surrounding Lowcountry. Everywhere you look, you'll see one of our vehicles. Hilton Head Exterminators, here in the beginning, and we're still here, growing along with the communities we protect.
The life lessons that I learned playing football are priceless and started much earlier than my NFL career. As part of a team, I learned accountability, discipline, and the value of hard work. But the most important lesson is safety.
Keep your kids safe during practice and during the game. Educate yourself and your kids. Learn the symptoms of concussions and how to prevent them. Everything starts with fundamentals, but remember, safety is first. For more information, visit peacockloves.com.
One of the challenges I faced with picking a college was I'm a full-time firefighter, so I knew I would struggle with being able to take classes. TCL offers a flexible schedule, and I was able to complete 90% of my classes online. I earned a business degree in fire administration. I'm currently a lieutenant with the City of Beaufort, Town of Port Royal Fire Department. I'm Ross, and I made it happen, no matter what.
So as we start the second quarter, Beaufort is snapping the ball from their own 1 foot line. Tyler Haley, the freshman quarterback, is doing everything he can to get out of the end zone. I don't think he did. Did his forward progress get out of the end zone? And it looks like they're saying yes. And it doesn't look like it's by much.
You said he lost a half a yard the first time. He lost almost the other half.
Yes.
On that scramble.
Now from their own 6-inch line, if even that, it's third down. Haley takes it, tries the left side, and he gets rocked. And we'll see once again where they're going to mark his forward progress, and his forward progress did not get back to the line of scrimmage, and May River puts 2 points on the board with a safety. We haven't seen one of those all year, I don't think, have we?
You don't see them very often, that's for sure. Big play made there by Rod Grant, the co-captain, defensive end. 215-pounder. You see him there on the sidelines. They're going to give him credit for the safety.
We could have gotten long odds that May River's first score tonight would have been a safety.
had May River had the ball where they had spotted it before, they'd have been touching the goal line. They'd have actually been in the end zone. It's the front of the football. Beaufort was out of the end zone to begin the play. They were not at the end of the play. And so now it's 7-2, Beaufort. You can make the baseball reference if you'd like.
Okay. So Beaufort will punt the ball now. Jeffrey Smith has the ball in hand. Gets off a high punt and a nice deep one all the way down to the 33 or 4 yard line. So Jeffrey Smith does a good job of getting the ball downfield.
Melvin Liverman backs up, makes the catch, but then slips and puts his hand down and his knee touched.
Right knee
as
hit
well.
The ground.
Yep.
So May River will start from their own, about their 33-yard line. They trail it 7-2 here in the Cross County Bowl. 11:14 left in the first half. Ahmad Green takes it, gives it to Brandon Morales, who tries it up the middle, and looks like he gets the better part of about five or so. Let's see what Jeff Shane has on the sidelines.
Guys, during the quarter break, the All-Lowcountry Center, May River's All-Lowcountry Center, Gabe Long, was getting a retape on his left ankle. Didn't look like it was too bad. He's actually back out there on this series, so we'll see how that progresses. Also, an interesting defensive wrinkle from the Beaufort Eagles. Usually they play a 4-2-5 defense, but they have taken Jeffrey Smith, their free safety, and moved him all the way from the very back into more of a linebacker position. So they've got a seven-man front now to take on the May River running game, and so far it's proven very effective. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Jeff. His sideline report is brought to you by Turbyville, your local independent insurance agency that has you covered throughout the Low Country. Brandon Morales on the last play took the ball for a couple more. That brings up third down, a long two. And let's see if May Rivers sticks with the recipe that usually works for them. Ahmad Green takes the ball. He's got some room to run. He cuts it left. And Ahmad Green has a first down and a whole lot more, and he gets down to the Beaufort 30-yard line. So May River now sticking with their recipe for success, which is run it more, and continue to run.
Trey Smalls finally makes the tackle on Ahmad Green. Watch him here actually slow down and say, okay, where's my next step coming? Trey Smalls wrestles him down, but not after he got about five more yards.
So a fresh four from the 30-yard line from May River. Green takes it, give it to Morales right up the middle, and he picks up about five.
Morales. Where's the ball carrier?
And this should really be their recipe until it's established that Buford can stop them, because this is what they do so well.
Morales and Ahmad Green have run for over 1,300 yards together. That was coming into this game. Jeffrey Smith kind of as an outside linebacker here, number five.
And the ball goes up the middle again. Not quite as much happening on that play until the very end, but the whistle was already blown. That'll bring up third down. Village Park Homes is your true hometown builder. They're close to everything, but far from ordinary. Village Park Homes. That'll bring up now third and two. Morales in the backfield. Hagen lined up wide left. Ahmad Green's going to keep it up the middle, and he's got a first down, just plows forward, gets down inside the 15-yard line. Jeffrey Smith on the tackle.
He ran right over Kendrick Smith, 43, and took him even deeper into the secondary before he was tackled. Watch this again. He just goes bang right through Kendrick Williams, the junior.
Mike Rickenbaugh Chevrolet, before you buy, give us a try.
And Jeffrey Smith ending up being a part of that crew that was in on the tackle.
Green gives it to Morales. Morales around the left side. He's into the end zone for a TCL touchdown. Brandon Morales around the left side, shook off one tackle, and it was just a race to the end zone that he wins. Morales into the end zone for a TCL touchdown.
Brandon Morales' 13th rushing touchdown of the year. And boom, he went right over Kendrick Williams. Williams has just been hit by a truck twice.
Last two plays.
Got the license number of 10 and the license number of 6. That's about all he knows.
Call 911. The kick is up, the kick is good, and as we go to break, May River takes the lead 9-7 here in the Cross County Bowl. We'll be back right after this.
Turbyville Insurance Agency has you covered in Beaufort, Bluffton, and throughout the Lowcountry. We are your independent insurance agency who will give you choices for peace of mind on your home, auto, business, life, health, and retirement plans by finding the best combination of price, coverage, and service. At Turbyville Insurance, we'll keep up with your changing insurance needs and are committed to customer satisfaction. Call us today and experience the Turbyville difference.
Before TCL, I was trying to find what school, what college would be the best fit for me. I come from a single family home and I couldn't ask my mom to pay a whole lot of money just for my education. And that's when I realized that TCL was the one that was going to offer me peace of mind for my financial situation. They've offered me great quality education at a low cost. I'm on a transfer block to transfer over after the semester. I am Antonia and I made it happen no matter what. Yo lo hice posible, no importa qué.
And May River kicks it off with a 9-7 lead now. Ball takes one bounce. Trey Hayward picks it up. Tries to make a little something happening, but good coverage by May River. They'll take over let's see where they're going to mark it here. Looks like on their own 26 or so yard line, maybe the 25-yard line. Technical College of the Lowcountry, make it happen no matter what. So Beaufort takes over now. Tyler Haley in a quarterback. They trail it 9-7. Haley takes it, throws it across the middle, a little low for Reed Rochelle, and it'll bring up 2nd and 10.
That time Haley just wound up and threw the fastball and threw it low.
Those bounce passes don't count.
We'll bring up a 2nd down and 10 from the 25.
Haley looking in. His brother Matthew, number 87, saying, throw it to me. At least I think that's what he said.
Something like that.
Something like that. Haley takes it, gives it this time to James Dagan, who tries the left side, and he loses a couple. That'll bring up 3rd and long.
Haley trying to accomplish a couple of things here for the Beaufort offense. Number one, of course, is to look to the future. He's the freshman. He's the guy in the coming years. But just as importantly, it's giving Jeffrey Smith a little bit of rest. Smith having to go both ways. And with his change of position to more of a linebacker position, he's getting hit by a blocker on every play when he's playing on defense. So just to give him a little bit of a breather, certainly helping out the Eagles.
Maybe he should go to Elite Physical Therapy. Be an advocate for your health care. You have a choice, choose the best. Tyler Haley takes a low snap, picks it up. Did very well not to turn it over, but May River with great penetration puts him right down, and just like that, it'll be 4th down and Beaufort will have to kick it away.
Travis Polite Grant, backup defensive lineman in there on the tackle. He'll get credit, not for a sack, but certainly for a tackle for loss. 4th and 11, and Jeffrey Smith has to come back on the field because he's also got a punt.
And it looks like we might have a false start on the Beaufort line, and that'll make it 4th and even longer.
For the snap. On the offense. 5-yard penalty, still 4th down.
So James Waldrop confirming what we saw. So 4th and 27 now. Smith takes it on the good snap, gets off a pretty good looking punt there. Went nice and high, but not as far as he would have liked. Gets out to about the 38-yard line, and May River is going to start with a short field. So Beaufort has put themselves in the hole with poor field position the last couple times, and they're paying the price for it. And with this running attack of May River, I think we're going to see Ahmad Green and Brandon Morales keep doing what they're doing. 6 minutes left here in the first half of the Cross County Bowl. OT Decor offers unique lighting designs. Visit their website, otdecor.com, to find the perfect accent for your home. And on 1st down, Morales plows forward, gets close to the 1st down, might be just a bit short. And he's sneaking up on that 1,000 yards.
Morales offers a little extra speed than they had from Cam Adams last year. Adams, more the bowling ball kind of running back. Morales gets out on the open field, he can turn it on. His 13th touchdown on their last possession.
Green takes it, immediately throws it out to the right side there, and it looked like Jack Hagan wanted to take off and do some running before he actually had possession of it. And he had a little bit of open field there.
He started running before he caught the football.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1.
Great call on 2nd and 1, though. We talk about this team wanting to run as much as possible, but have a little fun on 2nd and 1.
Have an opportunity to try a little something. Morales gets the ball, goes forward, and he's got a 1st down. And this May River drive stays alive. Don't forget the Charles Sampson team at Charter One Realty sponsors our MVP award at the end of the game, so stick around for that to see who will take home the nice plaque that Mr. Sampson likes to give out.
We again got a little confused by the down and distance marker. third and seven.
Ball goes to Morales up
the
middle,
seven.
And he's got a sprint to the end zone. And for the second time tonight, Brandon Morales is in for a TCL touchdown. And once he hits that open hole, as you just said, he's got that little extra gear that he picks up quick, and nobody else could get their hands on him. And for the second time tonight, Brandon Morales is in the end zone.
...25-yard score for Morales.
The extra point kick is up, it is good, and as we go to break, May River now takes a 16-7 lead. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome to the new Southern Carpet Wholesale. I guess after 16 years, we just got a little too big for our britches. That's right, the largest stocking dealer in the Lowcountry just got a little bigger, and nobody beats our prices. So come visit our brand new 12,000 square foot showroom and warehouse. It's chock full of wood, vinyl, ceramic, and of course, carpet. We're located in the Beaufort Town Center on Boundary Street. And remember, we go to Dalton so you don't have to.
Beam Graphics Printing Company. We specialize in custom printing, screen printing, embroidery, engraving, trophies, team uniforms, business uniforms, signs and banners, and much more. We are conveniently located in the heart of Bluffton at 12 Johnston Way across from the post office. For all your printing needs, call the locals at Beam Graphics, 843-837-9663. You can also check us out online at beamgraphics.com and like us on Facebook for specials and design ideas.
At Georgia Southern University, we're setting the standard for higher education in Southeast Georgia on three exciting campuses in Savannah, Statesboro, and Hinesville. We're offering more opportunities for hands-on learning, more ways to help our students find a career, and more economic impact on our region. At Georgia Southern University, discover more, connect more, be more. Florida and South Carolina residents get in-state tuition at our Armstrong and Liberty campuses.
Nick Lewis set to kick off. Short kick, we have whistles blowing, so it appears as though we're gonna get to do that again. With 5:02 left here in the first half, Brandon Morales goes into the end zone for the second time, puts us where we are with May River ahead.
We got a dead ball foul before the kick. Offsides on the kicking team. 5-yard penalty, still a free kick.
So they'll back May River up 5 yards, and they get to do it again. Nick Lewis said, I didn't like that kick anyway. I just soon try it again.
Back to the 35. Well, move the guys around a little bit.
Turbyville is your local independent insurance agency that has you covered throughout the Lowcountry. Turbyville Insurance. Here comes Nick Lewis to do it again, and it's a little pooch kick down. Signal for a fair catch at the 36-yard line by Reed Rochelle. And that's where Buford will be back in business. Now we'll see if Jeffrey Smith or Tyler Haley will come out at quarterback.
Buford's got to change the momentum now, as May River has really started to dominate defensively and take care of good field position and then pound home two touchdowns in the last 3 minutes. Buford led this game 7-0 at the quarter. It's been all May River here in the second.
Jeffrey Smith is back in at quarterback. James Dagan in the backfield with him. They trail it 16-7. Smith takes it, hands it off to Dagan, who tries the left side, has a little room to run, and Dagan picks up the better part of about 9. Bring up second and short.
That's how you counteract that pressure from the corners. If you can get Dagan outside of those two corners who are pinching in, then you've got a chance to get some running room going and make some yardage.
Buford signaling in the offensive signs with their signs of Mickey Mouse and Coca-Cola and a few other things. Quick pass out there to the side looking for Trey Hayward. It was a little low. That'll bring up third and short. Peacock Auto Mall. Find it all at Peacock Auto Mall.
Again, Bryce Liebrand, the offensive coordinator at the controls tonight. Devontae Holloman out.
James Dagan tries the left side, and he might have lost one or two. So Beaufort had second and about one, then it was third and two, and now they've got a fourth down situation with 4:15 left in the first half. And they've got the better part of three.
You mentioned Devontae Holloman not on the Beaufort sidelines tonight, taking care of family issues. His younger sister passing away suddenly last Thursday, and he wasn't quite right on Friday night, we could tell.
Yep.
In the Bluffton game Friday night, and it's pretty much taken this week to be with family instead of the team. We certainly understand. There you see Coach Liebrand calling his team over to talk things over on fourth and four. It's a Village Park Homes timeout.
Hilton Head PSD offers convenient and secure online billing. Just have your PSD bill handy and click on the online bill payment button at hhpsd.com. You'll be guided through the steps to establish your online billing account. Their payment options allow you to set up recurring credit card payments, you can view your consumption history, and more. Remember to have your PSD bill handy when you visit hhpsd.com to get started. Hilton Head PSD, we're always working for you.
Have you been hurt on the job, injured in a car accident, experiencing marital difficulties? Nairt and Dubois are attorneys located on the south end of Hilton Head Island. With their extensive experience and knowledge of the law, they can help you on your legal matter. Nairt and Dubois offer free initial consultation. So whether you have been hurt on the job, injured in a car accident, or experiencing marital difficulties, call the attorneys of Nairt and Dubois now to schedule an appointment to learn about your legal rights.
So as we come back in on fourth and three, Beaufort is opting to punt. Jeffrey Smith back. They trail at 16-7. And they decided to put 11 men on the field, which is a good thing. Low snap by Smith, who does a great job of picking it up and getting it off, and gets off a nice kick. It's going to take a bit of a Beaufort bounce and get inside the 20-yard line.
Coaches on the May River sideline arguing that Smith's knee touched the ground when he fielded that low snap before he was able to get the kick, which would, of course, put him down at that spot. The officials not going to go for that, but Rodney Summers going to argue his case.
Can we take another look at that? That would be interesting to see.
You're asking that, of course, rhetorically.
Yes. Okay, so May River back in business here. Just over 3.5 minutes left in the first half. Ahmad Green looking to throw, but now he's going to try to run it, and he's taken down from behind by Brandon Smalls. So number 10 takes down number 10. Is that allowed? That's allowed.
Smalls got a big piece of Ahmad Green's jersey right there. Said, yeah, down. Jeffrey Smith helping out to finish things off there.
OT Decor offers unique lighting designs. Visit their website, otdecor.com, to find the perfect accent to your home. OT Decor. Green gives it to Morales on second and 10. Morales just goes straight forward and picks up probably the better part of about 7 or 8.
Jeffrey Smith. Yep, and on the tackle. He's got to be the Will Kelly tonight. He's got to really take over as the senior leader on defense. If you missed us at the top of the show, Will Kelly, the all-area linebacker for Beaufort, in concussion protocol after a hit, he told me before the game, came last week in the second quarter, was able to play through the rest of the game, but then the headaches began, and said he has had now a full day without headaches, so he hopes to be able to play next week.
Ahmad Green takes it forward, gets a first down for May River, and they'll get a fresh four.
Tackle made by Kaye Little, the guy who actually is replacing on the roster anyway, in the lineup.
with the great Will Kelly.
Don't forget to stick around at halftime. Bob and I with the Mike Rickenbaugh Chevrolet halftime show. We'll be going over what happened in the first half and what we might expect to see in the second half. Under 2 minutes now, Green takes it, rolls to the left, doesn't have much time. Throws a pass nicely though. And that's caught by Jack Hegan. He's got a first down. So on a few balls that Hegan dropped earlier that were a little bit easier to catch, he comes up with a nice catch here. And nice footwork.
Hegan has, I believe, the only two catches in this first half for either team. Caught one down near the goal line in the first quarter.
Green looking to throw it again. Narrows it out down the middle.
Jeffrey Smith in the Green's coverage. Pass.
That time he was looking for Micah Burton.
Burton kind of a tight end H-back. That could be a very good play for May River down the road. As set Green up. You can tell he has the arm. Set him up, let him throw to a tight end, that H-back like you see Burton set up right now as the H-back.
Second down and 10 from the 36. Morales gets the ball. Picks up maybe three. That'll bring up third and 7 now. Clock is running. Getting down to about a minute and a half left in the first half of the Cross County Bowl.
33, Theo Washington in the game with a very clean uniform. He gets it a little dirtier that time by making the tackle.
Ahmad Green looking in, gets his signals from Coach Summers. Takes it, fakes it to Morales. He rolls to the right and he throws it out there looking for Micah Burton again, but some good penetration by Beaufort hurried his throw, and that'll bring up fourth down.
First time Buford's really gotten some penetration and put some pressure on Ahmad Green.
Terry fields back the punt for the Sharks.
And it'll set up a fourth down, likely a punt situation for Terry Fields and his May River Sharks.
Fields kicks it lefty, as we mentioned before. Good snap, gets his kick away, and nice high kick headed toward the left side. And once again, it takes a favorable May River bounce. And Buford will have to start from inside their 10-yard line. So a couple times tonight on fine kicks from Terry Fields, they've gotten it down inside the 10-yard line, one of the times down to the 1-yard line. And with under a minute left, Buford, if anything, just wants to make sure they don't turn this one over. Oh, yeah. And there's the trophy tonight for the winning team. The plaque sitting next to it is for the game MVP. And all clad out in pink tonight with their blue Shark hats are the, at least right now, the happy May River fans as they lead this one 16-7.
Hey, it's Friday night. After the week we've been through, they're all happy.
And left side of screen there, oh, they didn't offer us any pizza. What up with that?
Jeffrey Smith in at quarterback.
Smith takes it, looking to throw, throws it out on the left side, and we have the old hook and ladder to Mike, or to James Dagan there, who takes it upfield, and it looks like we're going to get something tacked on at the end there. So nice to see the hook and ladder. Buford trying to open it up just a little bit here before halftime, looking for a big play. And it appears as though they had one. Is it coming back or moving farther forward? See what James Waldrop has to say.
Got a block in the back on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Mark it off. Still first down.
And the penalty is from the spot of the foul, which was way upfield. But the old hook and lateral. Rischel catches the short pass, laterals it back to Dagan. They got Haley running down the field ahead of him. But a block in the back will bring it back at least 10 yards.
Smith's pass falls incomplete. So Beaufort looking to mix it up a little bit here with under a minute left. Ball will now be at the 28-yard line. 45 seconds left in the first half here of the Cross County Bowl. May River leads it 16-7.
Couldn't run it back-to-back plays, could you?
Well, they could. Whether or not they will, I don't know. Dagan stays in the block. And there's a long pass to, well, it was a good attempt that time. It ended up a little bit closer to Jaden Boyd than it did anybody on the Beaufort Eagles. And we might have had a wrong route run, so to speak. And we do like football. Let there be no doubt about that here at WHHI Sports.
Third down for the Eagles.
Will we call that last play the somebody please go long because I'm going to throw it down there and nobody did?
Something like that.
Something like that. Third down, Jeffrey Smith rolls to the left. Throws it down the sideline, and that one is almost picked off there by Terry Fields. It looked like he had it in his hands, and it just slipped through. And that'll bring up fourth down.
Fields has three interceptions already on this season. Almost had number four. Probably should have had number four. And so now, instead of just being in the shotgun formation, Jeffrey Smith will drop a little further back to catch the snap and punt it away with 33 seconds left.
Smith takes it, better snap this time, gets a kickoff. And we have a fair catch there by Terry Fields. And with 26 seconds left, May River will have the ball on their own 41-yard line. And we'll see if Coach Rodney Summers decides to just run things out or maybe tries to get a little something happening here before the half.
Been a very good quarter for May River. They were down 7-0. The change of possessions. It has been all Sharks here in the second.
Ahmad Green in the shotgun position that he's been in all night. Brandon Morales in the backfield with him. And everybody looked ready, and now we're going to switch things up. Green takes it, looks to the outside, fakes the option. He's going to hold on to it. He gets over midfield down to the 48-yard line. That'll stop the clock. May River's going to take a timeout. We're going to take a Village Park Homes timeout.
Domestic violence is not about.
Your home is one of your greatest investments, so why let just anyone protect it? Come see our professional team at Kinghorn Insurance of Beaufort. As an independent insurance agency, Kinghorn of Beaufort can provide customized coverage to meet your needs, from flood and water damage to windstorm protection. Our team has the expertise and experience to meet your needs. We proudly represent the SageSure family of companies. So come see why we've been earning trust and building relationships since 1898.
The Hilton Head Home Builders Education Foundation has been providing local high school graduates in Beaufort, Jasper, and Hampton counties with scholarships for over 25 years. The Education Foundation is a 501c3 nonprofit charitable organization formed to support and raise funds for continuing education. Donations are vital to the success of the program. To become involved or to contribute to the Hilton Head Home Builders Education Foundation, contact HBA staff today.
So first and 10 now from the Beaufort 47-yard line. We're just over 20 seconds left here in the first half of the Cross County Bowl. May River leads it 16-7. Maude Green fakes the pass, comes back the other way for a little screen, well defended by Beaufort.
Brandon Bauer Sox tipping the ball away. Green made the good fake, but then the guy who was supposed to catch the little screen back the other way wasn't quite in the right spot.
The incomplete pass stops the clock with 18 seconds left. May River trying to tack on a little more something here before halftime. Morales gets the ball, tries the left side, picks up a couple, gets down about the 44-yard line, and it appears as though May River is going to let the first half run out. So as we come to halftime here at the Cross County Bowl, May River leads it 16-7. We'll have the Mike Rickenbaugh Chevrolet halftime show right after these messages.
May River 16.
Looking for a unique lighting fixture that'll have everyone talking? Check out OT Decor. We have thousands of lighting fixtures that are perfect complements to your house. We carry Kichler, Monte Carlo, Murray Fice, Savoy House, Siegel, and more. Visit our website at otdecor.com to find the perfect accent for your home. Or stop by our showroom and visit with our experienced professionals for a personal touch. While you're here, check out our custom cabinets and vanities.
Home is that magical spot where weekends happen. It's tea parties and superheroes. It's one more bedtime story. It's your first, your last, and everything in between. Home is where you belong. We get it. Whether it's your first home, your next home, or your dream home, we want to build you the very best home for your life. Let us help you get started. VillageParkHomes.com. Close to everything, far from ordinary.
Hi, I'm Chris Butler, owner of Butler Marine. We are your number one dealer in the Lowcountry for outboard boats, and we feature the largest indoor showroom in the Southeast. Butler Marine has a wide selection of new and used boats, including bow riders, skiffs, catamarans, and center consoles. We are the largest Key West dealer in the country and the largest Yamaha dealer in the area. With our large parts department, we have any part you need, and we can even store your boat at our new dry stack facility in Port Royal. You can visit us at butlermarineinc.com. Butler Marine, come visit us and discover the difference.
We welcome you into the Mike Rickenbaugh Chevrolet Halftime Show. Chris Tremblay along with Bob Stevens. May River leads it here 16-7 in the Cross County Bowl. It took them a little bit to get going, but once they did, Brandon Morales and Ahmad Green started moving it downfield pretty good.
Well, Buford's defense, give them some credit early on in the game for allowing May River to march down the field, but then stopping them. And then Buford marched down and scored. Took a 7-0 lead. I think really kind of surprised the folks here at May River High School. But then, May River got it going. Their offensive line started to take command. Brandon Morales scored two touchdowns, and they got a defensive safety, so they put it all together, certainly in the second quarter, to take the lead.
Buford started to show some life on offense, but they need to get some better field position.
Yeah, they really do. They've been pinned. Terry Fields has done a great job of punting and laying them back inside their own 10. That's where the safety came from, as he kicked it down to the 1, and then they couldn't get it out from there. So, they've got it. They've got to try to show something. They did maybe the little hook and ladder play late in the half, maybe shows that they may try a little razzle-dazzle in the second.
Jeffrey Smith, the quarterback, he's been up on the line a lot. Only because Will Kelly hasn't been in, we might see a little bit more of Tyler Haley in the second half.
We might. Again, Jeffrey Smith goes both ways normally anyway, but having to play more of a linebacker than a free safety in the defense with Will Kelly out, that's worn him out. And they've put Tyler Haley in to spell him a little bit at quarterback. You know, when you have to take your quarterback out, that's never good.
No. Once again, May River leads at 16-7 here at the Cross County Bowl. Coming up next here is the Mike Rickenbaugh Chevrolet Halftime Show continues. Jeff Shane will have May River AD Brett Macy right after these messages.
Elite Physical Therapy has enjoyed being your physical therapy provider for the past 10 years. They focus their attention individually with each and every patient, providing a hands-on approach to accelerate your recovery so you can get back to the active lifestyle to which you're accustomed. At Elite Physical Therapy, you'll be treated by the same licensed physical therapist every session to work towards goals you set together. Take control of your health care and choose the best in physical therapy.
Turbyville Insurance Agency has you covered in Beaufort, Bluffton, and throughout the Lowcountry. We are your independent insurance agency who will give you choices for peace of mind on your home, auto, business, life, health, and retirement plans by finding the best combination of price, coverage, and service. At Turbyville Insurance, we'll keep up with your changing insurance needs and are committed to customer satisfaction. Call us today and experience the Turbyville difference.
Be part of something great. Join the CBC First Federal Bank family. A history of strength and a vision for the future. CBC National Bank and First Federal Bank are coming together to become an even stronger community bank. We're focused on vibrant communities, successful schools, growing businesses, and financial stability. We were voted again by the community as the 2018 Beaufort Gazette Best Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Before TCL, I served in the military for 5 years. So I knew I didn't want to be a single mom in the military. So I did decide to go to school. My whole family has graduated from TCL and has had great success here. Right now, I'm a recent nurse graduate. I want to be a nurse practitioner. I can't think of what TCL hasn't done for me. I am Thomasina Smalls, and I made it happen no matter what.
Back at halftime at the Shark Tank, where May River leads Beaufort 16-7. Unbeaten May River leads Beaufort 16-7. With me is the May River Athletic Director, Brett Macy. And an unbeaten team, what has the atmosphere been like around this campus now for a good 2 months?
It's been fun, certainly, not just campus, but the community. Our stands have been filled week in and week out. So, you know, I love it. The students love it. The community loves it. I'm happy for our players. They've worked extremely hard in 3 years. Our coaching staff, you know, coming down, most of them from Columbia, leaving an established program to start anew. So everyone's really just kind of feeling the fruits of their labor. So it's been awesome.
When you hired Coach Summers, obviously, you knew that he could turn an expansion program into something very good. But being a winning program and being an unbeaten program are two different things. Has it been a little bit of a surprise that it's come this far this fast?
Well, when you're unbeaten, you never really plan to be unbeaten. You know, you need some breaks along the way. But if you know, people paid attention year one, you saw we were getting beat 35-40 most Fridays. Last year, every single game was within a touchdown. So this year, everyone's back. So the progression was there to be very good. And we're just kind of where we're at. Tonight's a great test for us because Beaufort is easily the most physical team we've played, and we need that moving forward, heading to Battery Creek and Wade Hampton, next two region games, and into the playoffs. So tonight's been a great test.
The coaching staff, what did you see, perhaps, in Coach Summers that said he's the guy for this program at this time?
Well, I had criteria. We had about 75 applicants for the job, and it needed to be someone who had either started a program or turned a program around and had success. And Coach Summers really fit that bill, and his staff. They not only started Westwood, they turned it around in 3 years, made a big run in the playoffs in 4A. So really, you know, I'm glad those guys decided to come down, and it was really those two factors that put all those guys over the hump, not just Coach Summers.
Coaches take it one game at a time. You as a basketball coach did that just as well as anybody. But as an athletic director, do you look ahead? Do you look at the playoffs, see who's on the other side, how far this team possibly can go?
I'm too busy for that, unfortunately. I have other things to worry about, but I obviously hear the coaches talk, and really it's going to come down to where we finish in the region. You know, if we get a one seed, then you're a paired away from Dillon and Strom Thurmond, two very good powerhouses in 3A. If you're a two seed, then all of a sudden you have to play them a lot earlier. But, you know, anytime you have a good offensive line, which we have, we win in the trenches, which we do, it carries you a long way in the playoffs.
Let's talk about some of the other programs that are going on here at May River. Swim team finished up. They were fifth. Both the boys and the girls at state. Volleyball has played all right, and cross country just won a meet. Talk to me about the kind of what else is going on with the Sharks.
Yeah, again, off to a good start. Last year we finished second in the Carlisle Cup in 3A behind Bishop England, so that was a huge finish in our second year. Swim, the boys and the girls both finished fifth in the state at the state swim meet in South Carolina last weekend. The girls won the region championship for the third straight year. Volleyball is poised to get a two seed with a win next week against Wade Hampton. And then cross country, the boys just picked up a huge win in Charlotte in the Wendy's Invitational and beat a lot of really good cross country teams from across the Southeast.
You mentioned the third straight region champion for the girls swim team. You've won other region championships in other sports already. What kind of tradition is that setting here for the Sharks in just your third year as a program? 2 years and 2 months, essentially.
Well, we talked about it from day one, and it's not just swim team, it's not just football, it's the entire athletic program. And we want to compete at the highest level, whether it be against Bishop England for the Carlisle Cup, whether it be when we go 4A against Hilton Head and a couple other big schools. That's our goal, and all the coaches are all in on that. It's an awesome group. They pull for each other. They go to each other's games, and you know, I just love being around it.
You mentioned the Carlisle Cup, and for those that may not know, that is the all-sports trophy that goes to the best school in all sports for all at 3A, at 4A, at 5A, finishing second in the Carlisle Cup to a perennial power in Bishop England. And Hilton Head, by the way, has won 7 or 8 consecutive Carlisle Cups. How important is that Carlisle Cup when it compares, when you hold it up just against the individual sport success?
It's extremely important. You know, you don't have that success without individual right. success, obviously. But, you know, that's our goal, to be the best athletic program in town, in the county, and possibly in the state if we can. That's everyone's goal here, and that's what we strive for every day.
We appreciate you dropping by. Brett
Thanks,
Macy,
Jeff.
The athletic director at May River. Not only football, it's a great football season, but check out the other sports as well. We'll be back for the second half. It's 16-7, Sharks over the Eagles. Right back after this.
Your home is one of your greatest investments, so why let just anyone protect it? Come see our professional team at Kinghorn Insurance of Beaufort. As an independent insurance agency, Kinghorn of Beaufort can provide customized coverage to meet your needs, from flood and water damage to windstorm protection. Our team has the expertise and experience to meet your needs. We proudly represent the SageSure family of companies, so come see why we've been earning trust and building relationships since 1898.
Hilton Head Island's pristine beaches are one reason the area has boomed over the past 50 years, and Hilton Head Exterminators was there in the beginning. We covered the island, protecting homes and businesses as the island's first pest control company. Since then, we've expanded to protect homes and businesses beyond the island into Bluffton and the surrounding Lowcountry. Everywhere you look, you'll see one of our vehicles. Hilton Head Exterminators, here in the beginning, and we're still here, growing along with the communities we protect.
Hi, I'm Chris Butler, owner of Butler Marine. We are your number one dealer in the Lowcountry for outboard boats, and we feature the largest indoor showroom in the Southeast. Butler Marine has a wide selection of new and used boats, including bow riders, skiffs, catamarans, and center consoles. We are the largest Key West dealer in the country and the largest Yamaha dealer in the area. With our large parts department, we have any part you need, and we can even store your boat at our new dry stack facility in Port Royal. You can visit us at butlermarineinc.com. Butler Marine, come visit us and discover the difference.
Looking for a unique lighting fixture that'll have everyone talking? Check out OT Decor. We have thousands of lighting fixtures that are perfect complements to your house. We carry Kichler, Monte Carlo, Murray Fice, Savoy House, Siegel, and more. Visit our website at otdecor.com to find the perfect accent for your home. Or stop by our showroom and visit with our experienced professionals for a personal touch. While you're here, check out our custom cabinets and vanities.
And we are ready to begin the second half here of the Cross County Bowl. May River leads it 16-7. I'm Chris Tremblay along with Bob Stevens, and Jeff Shane will be on the sidelines with his continued good report. And Nick Lewis's kick is out of bounds, and we have a flag thrown on the play, as is what happens when you kick it out of bounds. And Beaufort, I think, is just going to take the ball.
And the Charles Sampson Real Estate Team MVP
will be selected and receive a trophy.
So Jeffrey Smith comes in at quarterback. He was in for most of the first half. Tyler Haley, the freshman, had a little bit of action. They trail it 16-7. Smith is going to go right to the air, and the ball is deflected and falls incomplete. He was looking for Reed Rochelle. That'll bring up second and 10.
Caleb Folk, the linebacker, getting his hands on it. 67 tackles this year for the senior linebacker. He, Jordan Barrow, Ridge Dow, Eli Hall, the four linebackers that have made a huge impression this year for head coach Rodney Summers. They played together now for the third year for a couple of them.
Smith takes it, and he's under immediate pressure, and he's going to go down. Right there, Roderick Grant got in the rush, and he didn't let Jeffrey Smith get out of his clutches there, and he's thrown for a big loss.
Well, Grant came from one side, Ridge Dow came from the other. There they are, pinching, and they got around the blockers on the offensive line for Beaufort early and quickly and put the pressure on Smith.
Exactly what Bluffton did last week when they beat Beaufort. Outside linebackers pinched all game and gave Smith more time. And it's happening again, and Smith's trying to get loose, but there's nowhere to go on third and 20. And just like that, Beaufort will be three and out, and May River should get the ball back.
Ridge Dow, 35, making the grab here. Got a little jersey, and then used that in order to get him around the waist and get him down. Michael Ludwig falling on top then.
The days of the tearaway jersey are no more.
Whatever happened to those good old tearaway jerseys, yeah.
I remember years ago watching Ed Marinero when he was a running back for the Vikings. His jersey was just torn to shreds every game. Smith gets off a good kick. Taking it midfield there.
Nobody
Harry Fields
knows.
Calls a full fair catch.
Nobody knows what number Archie Griffin wore at Ohio State.
Yeah.
Because they're always tearing the jersey away. You know?
I remember it was 45.
There you go. You saw him in the first quarter.
Exactly right. Exactly. May River will take over now at midfield. They lead it 16-7. Technical College of the Lowcountry. Make it happen no matter what. Ahmad Green in the shotgun as he has been all night. Micah Burton or Brandon Morales in the backfield with him. Morales picks Brandon up Morales about three.
Over 1,000 yards for the season. He needed 95 coming in. He now has 14 rushing touchdowns and 16 touchdowns overall. That's May River's seventh game of the season. An amazing story. Brandon Morales played on the JV team a year ago. Was a varsity player as a freshman.
Green keeps it. He's got some room up the middle. He's got a first down. He's down to about the 37 or 8 yard line, and May River now is starting to march.
George Williams, the junior linebacker, on the tackle, but Ahmad Green keeps it moving forward. Came into the game with over 400 yards rushing.
He came in averaging 7.2 yards a carry. Morales averaging 7 yards a carry. And they aren't even averaging the most. Travis Polite Grant is averaging 9 yards a carry. Green's going to keep it again. He's got some room to run, and he just keeps moving it right downfield. So Ahmad Green wanted to pass, but it was wide open in front of him, and he opted to run.
George Williams again making a tackle. It's okay when your linebackers are making the tackles when they're going forward. That means the defense is doing it right. When the linebackers are having to chase and make tackles, that's generally not a good sign. Again, Beaufort's defense really missing senior linebacker Will Kelly.
Another first down here. Morales gets the ball on the right side, and he gets down inside the 20-yard line.
Morales on the carry.
And May River, after a slow start this evening, they've really started to do what they do well, and that's run and run a lot.
Spotted at the 19-yard line, second down and four for the Sharks.
Second and four now. Green takes it, looks to go to the air, throws a soft one to the right corner, and that one's almost picked off. Good coverage again by Beaufort.
He would have been out of bounds had he caught it anyway. A little disappointed that he didn't make the grab.
It'll bring up a third down and four. Just inside.
So third and four now for May River. Ahmad Green looks in, getting his signal straight. Morales lines up just to his right. Micah Burton also in the backfield. Green's going to keep it. He's going to have a first down. He's inside the 10, inside the 5, and makes it to maybe about the 3 before Buford ties him up and softly tosses him backwards, I guess. Mike Rickenbaugh Chevrolet, before you buy, give us a try.
Great job by the right side of that offensive line. Gabe Long, the center, Connor Kovacs, the right guard, Will Wilson, the right tackle. Just moving the pile.
We're in the third quarter here of the Cross County Bowl. May River looking to increase their lead. Ahmad Green takes it right up the middle, and he does just that for a TCL touchdown. So Ahmad Green gets into the end zone for the first time tonight. May River starting to open it up a little bit.
Ahmad Green's fourth rushing touchdown of the season. He does have 12 touchdown passes. They haven't thrown the ball 12 times in this game. But tonight, Ahmad Green did most of the work moving him down the field. He gets to finish it off with the three-yard touchdown.
Extra point attempt is up. It's good, and as we go to break, May River takes a 23-7 lead. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome to the new Southern Carpet Wholesale. I guess after 16 years, we just got a little too big for our britches. That's right, the largest stocking dealer in the Lowcountry just got a little bigger, and nobody beats our prices. So come visit our brand new 12,000 square foot showroom and warehouse. It's chock full of wood, vinyl, ceramic, and of course, carpet. We're located in the Beaufort Town Center on Boundary Street. And remember, we go to Dalton, so you don't have to.
We are Palmetto Electric Cooperative, your Touchstone Energy partner. At Georgia Southern University, we're setting the standard for higher education in Southeast Georgia on 3 exciting campuses in Savannah, Statesboro, and Hinesville. We're offering more opportunities for hands-on learning, more ways to help our students find a career, and more economic impact on our region. At Georgia Southern University, discover more, connect more. Be more. Florida and South Carolina residents get in-state tuition at our Armstrong and Liberty campuses.
Hilton Head PSD offers convenient and secure online billing. Just have your PSD bill handy and click on the online bill payment button at hhpsd.com. You'll be guided through the steps to establish your online billing account. Their payment options allow you to set up recurring credit card payments, you can view your consumption history, and more. Remember to have your PSD bill handy when you visit hhpsd.com to get started. Hilton Head PSD, we're always working for you.
So with 8.5 minutes left here in the third quarter, May River takes a 23-7 lead. Trey Hayward takes the kickoff up the left side, gets out to about the 34-yard line, and that's where Buford will be back in business.
Curious to see now what the Eagles try to accomplish. Things starting to get away from them in this game. They need a score here, but how they do it, we'll be curious to watch whether they came out throwing earlier, and now they are coming out with both quarterbacks, Jeffrey Smith and Tyler Haley. Yep, Smith says, no, not your turn yet. Sends the freshman to the sidelines.
Oops. I was looking to see how that one was going to play out because I was counting 12 players. Okay.
Before the snap. Delay a game on the offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
So that'll back up Buford 5, and they'll be looking at first and 15. Village Park Homes is your true hometown builder. They're close to everything and far from ordinary. Village Park Homes. Immediately the ball is handed off there to Amari Morris, and he doesn't have much.
Morris, just a freshman. he never really, you know, looking for a hole, kind of moving and dancing his way down the line, and there was nothing to be had. Great pursuit by the defensive line of May River, led by Michael Ludwig, C.J. Lisbon, Roderick Grant.
Second and 14 now. Buford looking to get something going as they trail it 23-7. Nobody was on Ridge Dow, and they were smart not to go in his direction because he would have seen to it that they didn't go very far, and they didn't anyway.
Trey Hayward got the pitch. Trying to put their speed guys in to get outside that pressure being put from the two sides. Ridge Dow on one side, Roderick Grant, Jordan Barrow from the other side.
It's third down and 17.
So it's third and long now. Jeffrey Smith looking in, trying to see what play they can send on in to get them at least 17 yards for a first down. Smith takes it, he's under pressure again. He's gonna try to run, but he throws and finds a man there. Gets William Winburn, but they're still gonna come up just a little bit short. Depending on where they mark it, yeah, they're gonna be just about a yard short, and it'll be fourth. And let's see what Buford opts to do here.
I think they're gonna go for it. Yep, they brought James Dagan in, sent Amari Morris out. That's just their second pass completion of the game. They threw that little hook and lateral play to Reed Richel was the first completion, and then that one to Winburn, just the second completion for the Eagles.
So we'll see here on fourth and one what they do. They're gonna give it to Dagan up the middle, and Dagan goes nowhere. May River once again, there he is. Ridge Dow, who came into the game with 72 tackles, has increased that total by quite a few tonight. He got in there and didn't give Dagan anywhere to go, and May River's going to take over.
You give it to your bread and butter on fourth and one. Dow also was in right there. Also, Roderick Grant and Caleb Folk. Great job by the May River defense to hold, turn it back over to the offense in positive territory.
And back in business is Ahmad Green and company, and he's looking to air it out and strike quickly potentially, and he's gonna throw it deep, and we're gonna have a jump ball down there. James Hegan was the intended receiver. We have a flag, and we'll see what we're gonna get called here.
Hegan and Desmond Gaylord went up for the jump ball.
And it looks like we could have offensive interference.
Michael McGarry running up to James Waldrop to tell him what he
during
the
play. A pass interference on the offense. It's a 15-yard penalty. Replay first down.
And that's exactly what we have. And that's a pricey penalty. Once again, Buford has covered the long pass well tonight. Turbyville is your local independent insurance agency. They have you covered throughout the Low Country. Turbyville Insurance. So, first and 25 now. Green will air it out again. Buford with some good pressure, and just when they think they have him, Ahmad Green escapes and makes a little something out of nothing. And that'll still bring up second and long.
We have all lost our balance and stumbled forward a little bit. I don't think we've ever stumbled as far as he did right there and stayed on his feet. Ahmad Green.
That was a long stumble. Let's see what Jeff Shane is doing over on the sideline. Jeff, take it away.
After a kind of a rough second quarter trying to contain that May River running game, Buford has gone back to putting some of their players in more natural positions. Bowersox is back on the front in a crouch down lineman position. They're trying to rotate some guys like Kaye Little into that linebacker spot that was vacated when Will Kelly could not make it go tonight. They're really struggling to fill that spot. Kaye Little has seen time now at linebacker, and Jeffrey Smith, who was playing linebacker, they've moved him back into the secondary, and that might be for self-preservation with the way that their offensive series has been going the last couple of series. And if you remember the Bluffton game last week, Jeffrey Smith was absolutely gassed by the time the fourth quarter came around. Guys?
On the last play, Jack Hegan caught the ball, got May River back to a place where they're looking at third and 13, but that play was nicely broken up that time by Desmond Galliard, and that'll bring up fourth down. Jeff's Sideline Report is brought to you by Derbyville, your local independent insurance agency that has you covered throughout the Lowcountry.
Yeah, same pair, Desmond Galliard and Jack Hegan going for the ball. Hegan got called for the interference the first time. Dagan over the top to punch it away.
So on fourth and 13, Terry Fields is in to punt. Good snap. And the southpaw kicker gets away a nice kick. Fair catch signaled there by Reed Rochelle, and that's where Beaufort will take over. So with 4:40 left here in the first quarter, May River leads it 23-7. Beaufort gets the ball back, and I would say it's pretty imperative at this point that they're the next team to score.
Smart play by Reed Rochelle to go ahead and catch that, because every ball that has hit the ground off the foot, Terry Fields has gone forward and generally downed itself inside the 5-yard line.
Tough place to start from. OT Decor offers unique lighting designs. Visit their website, otdecor.com, to find the perfect accent to your home. That's OT Decor.
Bryce Liebrand, the offensive coordinator and kind of tonight's head coach, with Devontae Holloman away, dealing with a tragedy in the family, his youngest sister passing away suddenly last week. And Beaufort's players dedicating their game to him. You see the four on the back of the helmets. The May River players, of course, they are dedicating their season to Michael Mugridge, who passed away of cancer very early in this season. They've had a player wear number four in every game this year. Tonight, that player
is Daniel Matute.
Daniel Matute, a kicker. All right, two teams have broken their respective huddles. Cheerleaders reminding us how to do the Cotton Eye Joe, something.
Maybe reminding you.
Something Chris was very, very good at. Not too many years ago.
Something I used to excel at. Yeah. Tyler Haley throws it on over the right side to Trey Hayward. And Hayward picks up a couple.
Again, coming off that timeout, letting Haley come in as the quarterback, giving just that much more time for Jeffrey Smith to catch his breath, if nothing else.
Haley, the freshman, who's already garnered praise from the Beaufort coaching staff for the poise and dedication he's shown as a young person, and I think they're probably pretty glad to know they're going to have him for three more years after this year.
Last year, Tyler Haley is quarterbacking the team at Beaufort Middle School. And here he is leading the varsity, had a touchdown pass and a touchdown run against Valdosta a couple of weeks ago. And he is the future of Beaufort High, 3rd and 4.
Haley gets the snap, looks over to the right side. Ball is deflected that time. Ridge Dow had his hands on it.
Intended for Trey Hayward. It'll be fourth down, and Jeffrey Smith's little rest period is over.
Don't forget, the MVP award at the end of the game is presented by the Charles Sampson Group of Charter One Realty. One of our contenders is obviously Brandon Morales, the running back for May River, who has now passed over in this game the 1,000-yard mark for the season.
Incredible to do that in just 7 games. And again, even more incredible for not playing on the varsity a year ago.
Jeffrey Smith hits the punt. Looks like he took a little divot with his foot before he made contact with it. It actually has a little backspin. And that kick wasn't quite what he was looking for, and May River will start with a short field at about the Beaufort 45-yard line. First and 10 for the Sharks.
And Terry Fields gets just one little handshake from his teammates as he goes off the field. The rest of them were avoiding him like he'd had some sort of plague.
3:48 left here in the third quarter of the Cross County Bowl. May River leads it 23-7. Green takes the snap, throws it over to Jack Hegan on the right side. Hegan's got a little room to do something. And a nice open field tackle there
by Caden Grissom, number one. That time they kept Hegan back more toward the line of scrimmage instead of sending him deep downfield. He was wide open to catch that pass.
Elite Physical Therapy, be an advocate for your health care. You have a choice. Choose the best. Choose Elite Physical Therapy. Green takes it, wants to go to the right side again, and it looks like he just decided to let that one get away a little bit. Didn't like what he saw and said, let's try another
play. Again, intended for Hegan. A little shout out to number one coming off the field for May River. That's Melvin Liverman, their sophomore home run hitting wide receiver. He hasn't been in the picture much tonight, literally.
Yes, you're right.
He's been the lonesome end for May River.
Green's going to keep this one, try the left side. He's got a little running room, does a twist, and picks up a little something that'll still leave them short. They'll have fourth down coming up, but I got to believe they're going to go for it.
I think they will. Offensive lineman signaling over, yeah, we want to go for this. Fourth down, almost 4 yards to go. There's no doubt. The Sharks want to leave no doubt. That's their motto this year. Then they move quickly, early. Come on, Green.
For the snap, false start on the offense. It's a 5 yard penalty, still fourth down.
Ahmad Green goes over to Cameron Gleason and says, why did you do that? Now they'll punt.
Terry Fields back in to punt. Looking to pin Buford deep again.
Fields will want to hit this one. He did not hit the last one very well at all.
Fields, a low snap. Fair catch made there by Reed Rochelle inside the 10-yard line at about the 5.
The low line drive kick. He might have thought about running that one back, but had waved his arm as soon as the punt left Fields' foot. So Buford will start out inside their own 10. First and 10.
2:30 left in the third quarter. Hilton Head Exterminators, they're keeping Lowcountry homes and businesses bug-free and have been doing so for nearly 50 years. HiltonHeadExterminators.com. And the ball goes to James Dagan there, who tries to get them out a little bit. Might have picked up one, maybe two. Tyler Haley in a quarterback. The freshman still trying to get this offense going a little bit.
It's not a bad time to give him some snaps. Non-region game, so it really doesn't matter in the whole, you know, regional race. They'll host Hilton Head High next week. That one does matter. Give the freshman some snaps and see what happens. Uh-oh.
Well, you want to know what happens? He got downed at about the 1 foot line.
He's already been sacked for one safety tonight. They almost got another one.
Do you think in practice he takes that many snaps from his own end zone? My guess is no.
Travis Polite Grant making the play on defense for the Sharks. So now third and 15 from inside their own one.
Clock continues to run here in the third quarter. Haley takes it, throws it down the right side. He had a man down there. It was his brother Matthew. He was well covered though, and that'll bring up fourth down.
First time the two have tried to connect.
That's right. And a well-thrown ball.
Tell you what, good defensive play there.
Yep, was with him step for step.
By the corner. Don't think they haven't done that in a backyard a few times, though.
Terry Fields was hanging in the back there. He was making sure that nobody got by him. Jeffrey Smith now from the back of his own end zone gets the ball out. Gets away a pretty good kick that gets out to about midfield. Terry Fields decides to let it go, and it's come to rest at about the 47-yard line. So that's where May River will take over now with 1:25 left in the third quarter. Peacock Auto Mall. Find it all at Peacock Auto Mall.
Again, a dominant performance by the May River defense. We talk about Ahmad Green and Brandon Morales a lot, but the defense has just really taken any spice out of these Beaufort Eagles.
Beaufort's lone touchdown tonight came on a 95-yard drive, a long run by Jeffrey Smith, and then a horse collar call put more yardage on that, and they just crept it down. Sort of like Brandon Morales is doing right there. He picks up another first down, and the May River team is now down to the 31-yard line, threatening to go ahead and score again.
Jeffrey Smith again has to make the defensive play for Beaufort. As Morales gets free, Smith has to make the stop.
Micah Burton in the backfield with Ahmad Green and Brandon Morales. Green throws it on the right side there. Nobody was home. Jack Hegan was probably the intended target, but he was nowhere to be found in that area. That'll bring up second and 10.
As Jeff Shane told us in his last report, Beaufort going back to their usual positions on defense. Jeffrey Smith had been playing a free safety throughout much of the season. It kind of moved him up into a linebacker spot to help out in the absence of Will Kelly. Now he's playing a deep linebacker.
Ball goes to Morales up the middle again. He's got some room to run, and he's got another first down, and they're inside the 20-yard line. So a nice pickup there by Brandon Morales. That front line for May River opening them up, some nice holes. Number 69, big man. Prescott Ferguson opening up the hole for him, and Brandon Morales ran right behind him. I like saying that, the big man.
He is.
Yes, he is. Ahmad Green throws for the left corner. He's got somebody down there. It's Jack Hegan. And maybe it was just a touch underthrown.
Green's pass falls incomplete. Intended receiver number
15. Yeah, Hegan had to try to adjust his body to make that catch. Well covered by the Eagles secondary. So Hegan will hustle back. First to the huddle and then off to the sidelines.
Just over half a minute left here in the third quarter. Second and 10, Green gives it right to Morales and he just tries to plow ahead for a little bit more. Probably got about four.
Morales, the ball carrier.
There's the big man. 69, Connor Kovacs and Gabe Long, the center and the other guard.
And it appears as though May River is going to let the third quarter run out. So as we go to break here in the Cross County Bowl, May River leads it 23-7. We'll be back with the fourth quarter right after this.
Part of something great. Join the CBC First Federal Bank family.
a history of strength, and a vision for the future, CBC National Bank and First Federal Bank are coming together to become an even stronger community bank. We're focused on vibrant communities, successful schools, growing businesses, and financial stability. We were voted again by the community as the 2018 Beaufort Gazette Best Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Jeff Althoff here with Lowcountry Insurance. Let me ask you a couple questions. Do you trust your current insurance agent? Do you even know who your insurance agent is?
We are a trusted choice independent insurance agency. We make insurance human. Our expert agents walk you through hand-picked options with language you can understand. We are local and here to help you. Give us a shout, Lowcountry Insurance.
Elite Physical Therapy has enjoyed being your physical therapy provider for the past 10 years. They focus their attention individually with each and every patient, providing a hands-on approach to accelerate your recovery so you can get back to the active lifestyle to which you're accustomed. At Elite Physical Therapy, you'll be treated by the same licensed physical therapist every session to work towards goals you set together. Take control of your healthcare and choose the best in physical therapy.
The Hilton Head Home Builders Education Foundation has been providing local high school graduates in Beaufort, Jasper, and Hampton counties with scholarships for over 25 years. The Education Foundation is a 501c3 nonprofit charitable organization formed to support and raise funds for continuing education. Donations are vital to the success of the program. To become involved or to contribute to the Hilton Head Home Builders Education Foundation, contact HBA staff today.
As we start the fourth quarter here, Bay River looking at 3rd and 7, the beautiful piece of hardware that the winning team tonight will take home here from the Cross County Bowl, and the plaque on the left is for the MVP. That is presented by the Charles Sampson Group of Charter One Realty. And Charles Sampson is here in the stadium tonight and will be presenting that. 3rd and 7 now for Ahmad Green and company. They lead it 23-7. Green takes a low snap, tries the right side. He's got some room to run, and he's going to have a first down. And he's inside the 5-yard line, and May River looking to put this one on ice. And that was designed as a run the whole way. Some heavy blocking there on the right side. Connor Kovacs, Will Wilson, center Gabe Long, just moving the Beaufort line backwards.
That's why they were our MVPs in the victory over Bluffton High. Great offensive line play for the Sharks.
Green takes it, goes forward, and he goes waltzing into the end zone for a TCL touchdown. Ahmad Green gets into the end zone for the second time tonight, and May River ups their lead to 29-7.
Again, Green following Morales, among others. Brandon Morales out in front of him to help make the play. Now the extra point coming up.
Bryce Summers in to attempt the kick. Good snap, hold is down, kick is up. We heard some whistles blow.
For the snap, encroachment on the defense. It's half the distance to the goal. No, you can't, it's after the ready.
James Waldrop making it clear to Rodney Summers that the kick can't count. They have to do it again.
Yep. Can't decline that one.
Decline.
Well, they can decline taking it because they want to kick it from the 10-yard line again.
Summers will regain.
Yep, now they'll move it up. Now they'll move it back. They declined it.
Looks like you're moving your marker on the green, trying to figure out where to put the ball down.
That's a penalty.
Good
isn't
snap.
It?
Kick is up. Kick is good. And as we go to break, May River increases their lead to 30-7. We'll be back right after this.
The best bargains in the Lowcountry are at the Salvation Army Family Thrift Store in Beaufort. Stop in and see the selection and feel good knowing all items in the store are donated and all profits from them stay local to help families in need. There's 50% off colored tagged items every day, and you can also help by donating clothing, furniture, and other items in good, clean condition. All donations to the Salvation Army are tax deductible. Visit the Salvation Army Family Thrift Store at 164 Roberts Malls Parkway in Beaufort.
Jeff Althoff here with Lowcountry Insurance. Let me ask you a couple questions. Do you trust your current insurance agent? Do you even know who your insurance agent is?
We are a trusted choice, independent insurance agency. We make insurance human. Our expert agents walk you through hand-picked options with language you can understand. We are local and here to help you. Give us a shout, Lowcountry Insurance.
And we're ready to go here with the kickoff as May River leads it 30-7. Fair catch there, signaled by Reed Rochelle. They trail it 30-7 now, 11:36 left in the game here, Cross County Bowl.
Spotted at the 36-yard line, first and 10, Buford from their own 36.
Okay, so you're all making fun of me wearing the shark hat. I got it.
Production crew that is easily amused. Jeffrey Smith back in at quarterback. But then you're the kind of guy who creates easy amusement.
That's true. Jeffrey Smith takes it on the left side, looking to get a little something, and he does. And he gets darn close, and he will get a first down. So Jeffrey Smith, after taking a few series off, letting freshman quarterback Tyler Haley come in. On the first play, takes it over to left side, picks up about 12, and has an Eagle first down. And he looks a little tired.
Tell you what, give this guy, though, medals for the leadership he has shown, the ability to play offense and defense, the mentoring he is doing for Tyler Haley.
Immediate quick pass over to Trey Hayward, who picks up a couple getting out of bounds. Let's go over and see what Jeff Shane's up to. Jeff, take it away.
Guys, the interesting situation along the offensive line for Beaufort. Jeremiah Williams, the junior Jeremiah Williams, actually have two by that name, but his shoulder pads are off. His right shoulder is being wrapped, and he's done for the night. Interesting thing about that is that really makes them short along the offensive line. One of the other offensive linemen that he usually switches with is Brandon Bowersox. Well, Brandon Bowersox is wearing number 8 tonight and can't play the offensive line. So they're doing a little bit of mixing and matching, maybe more mixing than matching at this point, because there's only one offensive lineman that's still in the same position that he was to start the night. That's the left tackle, Caleb Haygood. They have moved a lot of guys around. It has been a real struggle. They've been in the shadow of their goalposts a couple of times tonight. Things will get better for Beaufort, but it's been a long slog tonight.
Thanks for that, Jeff. His sideline report is brought to you by Turbyville, your local independent insurance agency that has you covered throughout the Lowcountry. As Jeffrey Smith airs it out on 2nd and 14. He was going for Trey Hayward. Good coverage there by Terry Fields.
And by Jaden Boyd, yeah, the sophomore.
Good coverage by both teams on the longer passes tonight. They haven't let anybody get behind them, which was something that Beaufort, unfortunately for them, was not able to do well last week.
Yeah, so they've improved in that sense. Defensively, they've played a pretty good football game against the pass.
Smith throws a little screen there. And there goes James Dagan looking to pick up a first down, and he's gonna come up, it looks about 4 yards short.
Beaufort High will host Hilton Head High. Great rivalry game. next week. It's also a region game.
May River's next game is a home game against Battery Creek. Fourth and three now. Technical College of the Lowcountry. Make it happen no matter what.
Yeah, May River's big game comes up in about 3 weeks against Wade Hampton. That'll be for the region title likely.
Smith back to pass. He's under pressure. He's going to try to do it with his legs, and it's not going to happen. So on fourth and three, Jeffrey Smith trying to make something happen here. Can't find anybody open. The May River pressure eventually gets to him, and we're going to have the ball go back over to Ahmad Green and company. Number nine, Michael Ludwig ran him out of bounds there. The 6'1", 210-pound senior. Came into the game with 32 tackles on the season. Six of them for loss is losses.
So for all of the moving around and the shuffling that Beaufort has had to do on the offensive line, May Rivers had the same five guys out there all night. We'll tell you about them in a moment. Joseph Tapscott in to play quarterback for the first time.
He comes
for
into
the snap.
Game.
Encroaching on the defense. 5 yard penalty, still first down.
Tapscott comes into the game, completing all of his passes on the season. He's 12 for 12.
Joseph Whitaker, the left tackle. Big man Ferguson, the left guard. Gabe Long, the center. Connor Kovacs on the right side with Will Wilson. Those five have played all night long for the Sharks.
Morales gets the ball, and one of the few times tonight, there was nowhere to go.
It's William Winburn shaking his arm as if he might have got a little stinger to the shoulder there making that tackle.
Actually, one of the few times tonight that Morales has maybe lost anything. A 3 yard gain for him is almost a loss. Morales takes it again, same cut. This will be a first down. He's got more room to run. He gets down to about the 35 yard line. So Morales' total continues to build.
Pick up 15 after losing maybe a yard on the other carry. Great cutback by Morales. Great vision, finally thrown down by Caden Grissom deep in the secondary.
Village Park Homes is your true hometown builder. They're close to everything, but far from ordinary. Village Park Homes. Tapscott takes, it gives to Morales again. And once again, one of the few times Morales hasn't had anywhere to go, and Jeffrey Smith says, I'm gonna pile on this, and does a little jump, a froggy jump.
That's a smart play. If you're a defensive back and you want to look good on the film,
sure,
you got them going backwards. Yeah, let me jump on there too.
And your number is going to be the one that shows up.
You bet. The guys are going to call your name. He didn't make the tackle, but he looked like he did.
Would that be an assist?
Oh, sure.
They'll get an assist on that. Tapscott back to pass. He's going to do some running now, and he's being chased, and he's just going to throw this one out of bounds. Number 55, Kajon Jenkins was after him in hot pursuit.
Jenkins, one of the many guys being asked to come in and play linebacker with Will Kelly out. If you missed the top of the show, Kelly, the all-world linebacker for Beaufort High, was injured last week during the game. A head injury, has had headaches all week, now going through the concussion protocol. Told me before the game, I've just gone the last 24 hours headache free, so he feels like he'll be able to play next week.
Tapscott on third and 10, gives it to Morales, which isn't a bad choice, but Morales will come up short on this play. And now the clock is May River's friend as it continues to go. And we'll remind you about our friends at Elite Physical Therapy. Be an advocate for your health care. You have a choice. Choose the best. Elite Physical Therapy.
Brandon Bowersox grabbing Morales there and throwing him down. Morales was the quarterback, and this was the NFL. That would have been roughing the passer.
Most definitely. That would have been. You have to put down the blanket and the pillow now before you tackle the quarterback in the NFL. You have to be very gentle. Show love and respect.
Yeah, you want to watch guys play football? Come watch a high school
game. That's right. And some fine ones we've had. We're going to go to a Village Park Homes. We'll be back right after this.
Home is that magical spot where weekends happen. It's tea parties and superheroes. It's one more bedtime story. It's your first, your last, and everything in between. Home is where you belong. We get it. Whether it's your first home, your next home, or your dream home, we want to build you the very best home for your life. Let us help you get started. VillageParkHomes.com. Close to everything, far from ordinary.
Elite Physical Therapy has enjoyed being your physical therapy provider for the past 10 years. They focus their attention individually with each and every patient, providing a hands-on approach to accelerate your recovery so you can get back to the active lifestyle to which you're accustomed. At Elite Physical Therapy, you'll be treated by the same licensed physical therapist every session to work towards goals you set together. Take control of your health care and choose the best in physical therapy.
Hilton Head Island's pristine beaches are one reason the area has boomed over the past 50 years, and Hilton Head Exterminators was there in the beginning. We covered the island, protecting homes and businesses as the island's first pest control company. Since then, we've expanded to protect homes and businesses beyond the island into Bluffton and the surrounding Lowcountry. Everywhere you look, you'll see one of our vehicles. Hilton Head Exterminators, here in the beginning, and we're still here, growing along with the communities we protect.
And on fourth down, across the middle is a Tapscott pass for Jack Hegan, and he's going to have enough for a first down. And May River's drive continues here.
Joseph Tapscott, who was the starting quarterback as a freshman, is now a junior. Still got the arm. He flings that one into the Beaufort secondary for the first down.
Jack Hegan, the most targeted receiver tonight for May River. Took that one. And it's a little pass over to Morales on the right side, and not much happening there.
Kaye Little making another play, the senior, who's getting a chance to play because of the injury to Will Kelly. For a loss of four on the play. 30-7, May River on top. They are doing to Beaufort what they have done to a lot of schools this year in the third year of their program. First year they got hammered a number of times. Last year they played everybody close, and this year they're exacting some revenge. Same
payback
thing happened to Bluffton. Yep.
Melvin Liverman touching the ball for the first time tonight, trying to make something happen, and he gets down to about, looks like, the 17 or 18 yard line. So Liverman, the speedster, gets his hands on the ball and turns not much into a little more.
Yep, just a sophomore, but this year has just 9 catches for 81 yards. He's the kind of guy who could get 81 on any single play.
And then some.
Yep. Now Tapscott comes over and will be replaced by Ahmad Green.
We're going to have a timeout by May River, and that'll take us to a Village Park Homes timeout.
Looking for a unique lighting fixture that'll have everyone talking? Check out OT Decor. We have thousands of lighting fixtures that are perfect complements to your house. We carry Kichler, Monte Carlo, Murray Feiss, Savoy House, Siegel, and more. Visit our website at otdecor.com to find the perfect accent for your home. Or stop by our showroom and visit with our experienced professionals for a personal touch. While you're here, check out our custom cabinets and vanities.
The life lessons that I learned playing football are priceless and started much earlier than my NFL career. As part of a team, I learned accountability, discipline, and the value of hard work. But the most important lesson is safety. Keep your kids safe during practice and during the game. Educate yourself and your kids. Learn the symptoms of concussions and how to prevent them. Everything starts with fundamentals, but remember, safety is first. For more information, visit peacockloves.com.
Your home is one of your greatest investments, so why let just anyone protect it? Come see our professional team at Kinghorn Insurance of Beaufort. As an independent insurance agency, Kinghorn of Beaufort can provide customized coverage to meet your needs, from flood and water damage to windstorm protection. Our team has the expertise and experience to meet your needs. We proudly represent the SageSure family of companies, so come see why we've been earning trust and building relationships since 1898.
So with 6:49 left in the game, 3rd and 8 now. Tapscott back in a quarterback. Takes it, gives it to Morales, who they think can pick up the first down, and he's going to be just a little short.
Going to bring on the field goal team, and it's going to bring on Nick Lewis to get the crack at this one. Senior kicker.
Handles the longer distance guy.
Yeah, handles their kickoffs. More of the long guy, the left-footed kicker.
This one from about 31. And the snap is bobbled and nothing's gonna happen there. So Wilson Mullis tried to handle the snap, but ball slipped through his hands and nothing happening, no kick attempt there, and Beaufort will take over with 6:06 left in the game, trailing here in the Cross County Bowl, 30-7.
All right, Eagles make a stand. They'll try to do something here on offense, begin to create some momentum aiming toward next week. See who's going to play quarterback. They're going to let Tyler Haley run the show on this series. Again, an offensive line, though, that has been patched together throughout this evening.
Haley takes it. It looks like we might have had a little movement before the ball was snapped.
Before the snap, false start on the offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
And that'll march the Eagles back 5 yards. Bring up 1st and 15. Remember, OT Decor offers unique lighting designs. Visit their website, otdecor.com, to find the perfect accent to your home. OT Decor, as Tyler Haley tries to run it on the left side now and pick up a little something, and he's met by a wall of sharks. And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's go over to Jeff Shane.
Guys, as most of us know, Hurricane Michael, the scare that we came across the Lowcountry, cost both of these teams and really everybody 2 days of practice. No practice Wednesday, no practice Thursday. Now, they did have a walkthrough this morning, at least May River did, but these two teams are playing with their last workout actually being very, very, very long ago. We asked Rodney Summers about that during the week, and he remembered a time, it was his second or third year at Westwood High, where he came before May River, and he had a similar situation with the flooding up in Columbia. They were about to play Lugoff Elgin, and they lost a couple of days of practice. They had to go through the same situation. We asked him what happened when Westwood played Lugoff Elgin. Well, they won by about 3 touchdowns. Looks like it's going to be about the same tonight. On the Beaufort side, it has just made a tough week even tougher because with Coach Devontae Holloman missing a lot of time, poking his head in and out of practice, but basically being gone all week, they have really struggled to get their communication in tonight. Back to you guys.
While Jeff was doing his sideline report for us, Tyler Haley hit Reed Rochelle on a beautiful outplay there, and then on the long pass here, it appears as though we have pass interference against May River, and that's going to move the ball downfield.
Pass interference on the defense. It's a 15-yard penalty. First down.
So a fresh 4 for Beaufort here. Tyler Haley has the Eagles moving in the right direction. Mike Rickenbaugh Chevrolet, before you buy, give us a try. And the ball is on the ground. Haley to jump on it. Lucky to hold on to that one. They'll lose a few on that, but they do keep the ball.
Defensive play there made by C.J. Lisbon, who's battled injury throughout this season. Finally seems to be healthy. Playing on the defensive line for the Sharks.
Tyler Haley looking to the sideline there, getting all the
I wonder if we were ever going to see Haley and Amari Morris in together. Two freshmen
in the backfield there. Haley throws down the left side there, and he's got his brother, Matthew Haley, to the point where they're going to have third and short now. So nice little pitch and catch there between brothers. Maybe they practiced a little in their day off from the hurricane in the backyard. They're allowed
legal.
To do that, right?
I think that's legal, yeah.
The May River Marching Band, they're getting ready to compete tomorrow in a competition in Georgia. Nice pass, nice catch, pretty good defense. There goes Amari Morris across the line that got him the first down, and that's what they've got. So they keep the drive alive here with under 4 minutes left in the Cross County Bowl.
This would be a nice drive for Beaufort to finish off and maybe give themselves a good taste in their mouths as they prepare to play Hilton Head Seahawks next week in a big region game for both teams.
They will be hosting that one after being on the road the last 2 weeks. Nice long pass there from Tyler Haley looking for his brother who's maybe just underthrown. Nice defense there by Jaden Boyd as he was step for step with Matthew Haley.
A good job done by the defensive backs on both sides of the ball tonight. There have not been very many wide open receivers.
Second and 10 now for the Eagles. As the poster boards go, I wonder what the Mickey Mouse means. I'd be curious to know. Haley takes it and don't think they were really sure who was going to get it. Fortunately,
well, Morris had it, then dropped it, but then saw it pop loose and he fell on it. They're going to end up putting it pretty much at the original line of scrimmage and make it third and 10. The Beaufort faithful will be on home turf next week in the Eagle's Nest.
Haley trying to make something happen, scrambling around. And the May River defense gets to him again. Ridge Dow, who's tying his shoes there, has been all over the place tonight. Caleb Folk doing a little hobble off the field there. And on fourth down, we're going to have a Beaufort timeout. That'll take us to a Village Park Homes timeout. We'll be back right after this.
Turbyville Insurance Agency has you covered in Beaufort, Bluffton, and throughout the Lowcountry. We are your independent insurance agency who will give you choices for peace of mind on your home, auto, business, life, health, and retirement plans by finding the best combination of price, coverage, and service. At Turbyville Insurance, we'll keep up with your changing insurance needs and are committed to customer satisfaction. Call us today and experience the Turbyville difference.
Have you been hurt on the job, injured in a car accident, experiencing marital difficulties? Nairt and Dubois are attorneys located on the south end of Hilton Head Island. With their extensive experience and knowledge of the law, they can help you on your legal matter. Nairt and Dubois offer free initial consultation. So whether you have been hurt on the job, injured in a car accident, or experiencing marital difficulties, call the attorneys of Nairt and Dubois now to schedule an appointment to learn about your legal rights.
I just wanted something that was local and more affordable. TCL makes it easier for me to be a mom and go to school. Being able to pick my classes, pick the hours, work around my work schedule, take a lot of courses online, the friendly staff members, and it being affordable, it's the best option. I'm a second year student at TCL. I am Naomi, and I made it happen no matter what.
Haley takes the snap here on fourth and 10, throws it across the middle, was looking for his brother there, number 87, Matthew Haley. But it was broken up once again by Jaden Voigt, who was all over Haley, and May River will take over with just over 3 minutes left here in the Cross County Bowl.
Jaden Voigt's just a sophomore, and we've seen him play some great cornerback throughout all of our four May River broadcasts this season. He's going to be a good one.
Matthew Haley's going to think that his number was 20 after the way the Voigt was wearing him tonight. May River Scott in a quarterback.
Yeah, May River finally making some substitutions offensively. Cody Mosley is the running back carrying there, a senior.
And May River will be looking to just run it and run this clock down now. May River will go to 7-0. Buford will fall to 3-5.
Co-captain Chase Guynum, big number 71, making the tackle for Buford High. Been on the nose of that three-man front throughout much of the night.
Tapscott takes it. He's going to keep it. And he's upended there by Jeffrey Smith.
He's just a football player. Love the way he plays.
He'll sleep well tonight.
Yeah, we know how high school kids love to sleep in till like about noon.
No, we call it the crack of noon.
Yeah, okay. Well, give Jeffrey a couple extra hours. Don't ask him to do anything before about 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon.
Clock continues to run here in the Cross County Bowl. We're under 2 minutes now. Ball is handed off there to number 22, Michael Gonzalez. He picks up some yardage. Let's go to Jeff Shane.
Guys, as you mentioned, May River's going to 7-0 tonight. What happens from here? Well, next week they play Battery Creek. Battery Creek just won their first game last week. Then come two huge games. Wade Hampton for the region title, and that's at Wade Hampton in 2 weeks. And then after that, they'll play Colleton County in the makeup game for what we lost from the tropical storm earlier this year. The interesting thing about those last two games, they have a chance not only to beat every team in their region, they have a chance to beat every team in 7-4A. That's the Beaufort, Bluffton, Hilton Head region. Back to you.
Thanks for that, Jeff. Jeff's Sideline Report is brought to you by Turbyville, your local independent insurance agency that has you covered throughout the Lowcountry. We have a Village Park Homes timeout. We'll be back right after this.
We are Palmetto Electric Cooperative, your Touchstone Energy Partner.
The best bargains in the Lowcountry are at the Salvation Army Family Thrift Store in Buford. Stop in and see the selection and feel good knowing all items in the store are donated and all profits from them stay local to help families in need. There's 50% off colored tagged items every day, and you can also help by donating clothing, furniture, and other items in good, clean condition. All donations to the Salvation Army are tax deductible. Visit the Salvation Army Family Thrift Store at 164 Roberts Malls Parkway in Buford.
Welcome to the new Southern Carpet Wholesale. I guess after 16 years, we just got a little too big for our britches. That's right, the largest stocking dealer in the Lowcountry just got a little bigger, and nobody beats our prices. So come visit our brand new 12,000 square foot showroom and warehouse. It's chock full of wood, vinyl, ceramic, and of course, carpet. We're located in the Buford Town Center on Boundary Street. And remember, we go to Dalton, so you don't have to.
So with 1:36 left, we had an injury timeout. If we have time, Jeff Shane will keep us up to speed on what went on there. Clock continues to run now. May River leads it here in the Cross County Bowl, 30-7. Little slow start for their offense tonight. Scoring got started by James Dagan of Buford taking it in from just over 2.5 yards out. Put Buford ahead 7-0. May River then scored a safety, and it's been all the Shark ground game. The Sharks did it all on land tonight. We have another Village Park Homes timeout. We'll be back right after this.
Jeff Althoff here with Lowcountry Insurance. Let me ask you a couple questions. Do you trust your current insurance agent? Do you even know who your insurance agent is?
We are a trusted choice, independent insurance agency. We make insurance human. Our expert agents walk you through hand-picked options with language you can understand. We are local and here to help you. Give us a shout, Lowcountry Insurance.
Beam Graphics Printing Company. We specialize in custom printing, screen printing, embroidery, engraving, trophies, team uniforms, business uniforms, signs and banners, and much more. We are conveniently located in the heart of Bluffton at 12 Johnston Way across from the post office. For all your printing needs, call the locals at Beam Graphics, 843-837-9663. You can also check us out online at beamgraphics.com and like us on Facebook for specials and design ideas.
Fourth and six now for May River. They're going to punt. Terry Fields gets off another kick. A couple times tonight he has pinned Beaufort deep. That takes a favorable Shark bounce again, and that's going to get down to about the 19-yard line. And with under a minute left, that's where Beaufort will take over.
Eagles will fall to 3-5 with their fifth straight loss, and yet have an opportunity next week to right the ship against Hilton Head High. Then they will play Colleton County to wrap up region play.
Tyler Haley in a quarterback. Seen a little more action this week than he did last week against Bluffton. Hands it off there to James Dagan on the left side. And Dagan is doing everything he can to just keep things going. In the last two games, he has done all the touchdown scoring. Or I should say TCL touchdown scoring for Beaufort.
James is going to get the rest of the night off. These last 45 seconds. Comes off the field, replaced by Amari Morris.
Haley back to pass, and he's going to air it out down the left side. And that one was almost picked off there by number 17.
Matthew Gibbons.
There you go, thank you.
Yep, just a sophomore. Oh, he almost got that one.
This time of night with a little cooler air blowing in, it's ball's getting a little dewy, a little tough to hold on to. Need a pair of those gloves. Ball's given to Amari Morris, who tries to make a little something happen, and not much doing there.
See if Beaufort decides to run one more play or if they've had enough.
Don't forget to stick around for our post-game show, where we'll be giving out the team trophy and the MVP award presented by the Charles Sampson Group of Charter One Realty. And that will close things out here on the Cross County Bowl. May River goes to 7-0. They win it 30-7 over the Beaufort Eagles. We'll be back with the post-game stuff right after this.
Looking for a unique lighting fixture that'll have everyone talking? Check out OT Decor. We have thousands of lighting fixtures that are perfect complements to your house. We carry Kichler, Monte Carlo, Murray Feiss, Savoy House, Siegel, and more. Visit our website at otdecor.com to find the perfect accent for your home. Or stop by our showroom and visit with our experienced professionals for a personal touch. While you're here, check out our custom cabinets and vanities.
The life lessons that I learned playing football are priceless and started much earlier than my NFL career. As part of a team, I learned accountability, discipline, and the value of hard work. But the most important lesson is safety. Keep your kids safe during practice and during the game. Educate yourself and your kids. Learn the symptoms of concussions and how to prevent them. Everything starts with fundamentals, but remember, safety is first. For more information, visit peacockloves.com.
Hi, I'm Chris Butler, owner of Butler Marine. We are your number one dealer in the Lowcountry for outboard boats, and we feature the largest indoor showroom in the Southeast. Butler Marine has a wide selection of new and used boats, including bow riders, skiffs, catamarans, and center consoles. We are the largest Key West dealer in the country and the largest Yamaha dealer in the area. With our large parts department, we have any part you need, and we can even store your boat at our new dry stack facility in Port Royal. You can visit us at butlermarineinc.com. Butler Marine, come visit us and discover the difference.
Home is that magical spot where weekends happen. It's tea parties and superheroes. It's one more bedtime story. It's your first, your last, and everything in between. Home is where you belong. We get it. Whether it's your first home, your next home, or your dream home, we want to build you the very best home for your life. Let us help you get started. VillageParkHomes.com. Close to everything, far from ordinary.
And we welcome you into the post-game presentation for the Cross County Bowl. For the fourth time this year, May River here on the WHHI Bowl Series comes out victorious tonight, a 30-7 victory over the Beaufort Eagles. It started a little slow for them, but twice Ahmad Green got into the end zone, twice Brandon Morales got into the end zone, and coach, pretty good performance again tonight once you got warmed up. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you. It's to these guys right here behind me. Woo! 7-0!
You're going to have to build another trophy case just for these. That's four of them this year.
Yeah, that's four this year. And I told them, I said, guys, you know, we got to go out there and play. We can't lose our streak on TV tonight.
A little bit of a slow start, but then you hit the groove and the running game started to take over.
Yeah, we did. You know, I didn't think we could run the football. They came out a little different front. Saw them in an odd front. They've been even front and playing a little different. So we were able to take advantage of that, I think, tonight and hammer the football, you know, in the trenches. So this man right here, he surpassed, I believe, 1,000 yards tonight. So.
But we're going to talk to him and have a little sum for him in just a minute. Defense looked awfully good, too. They were really putting a lot of pressure on, and they didn't allow any time for Jeffrey Smith or Tyler Haley to throw the ball.
They did. Every time I came out from the tent making corrections, I look over there, and we're chasing the quarterback. We're containing them. And Coach Hatcher and Coach Powell and Coach Dyer, they do a great job on that defensive side. And hats off to the players over there. And, you know, they just something that we pride ourselves in, playing hard defense. So, you know, again, you got to do that if you want to get where we are right now.
You didn't have to make too many corrections on the offensive side of the ball tonight, did you?
Well, I think we had to just correct some of our mistakes and things that we were doing and kind of settled ourselves down a little bit, like the fumble and the motion and things like that. So we were our worst enemy early on, and then we kind of settled down.
Feel comfortable with what you saw tonight moving forward?
Yeah, definitely. You know, again, question mark this year coming in. All the guys wore question mark shirts. I think we've proven that none of these guys deserve to be a question mark right now.
Great stuff. Again, congratulations. 7-0. That was the one thing you told your team. You're pretty excited about that. I know they are.
Oh, I'm very excited. It's going to be a good night tonight.
Thanks so much, Coach Rodney Summers. We're going to be back with the MVP award presentation. Charles Sampson's right here. We'll have him in just a moment right here on WHHI.
Turbyville Insurance Agency has you covered in Beaufort, Bluffton, and throughout the Lowcountry. We are your independent insurance agency who will give you choices for peace of mind on your home, auto, business, life, health, and retirement plans by finding the best combination of price, coverage, and service. At Turbyville Insurance, we'll keep up with your changing insurance needs and are committed to customer satisfaction. Call us today and experience the Turbyville difference.
The Hilton Head Home Builders Education Foundation has been providing local high school graduates in Beaufort, Jasper, and Hampton counties with scholarships for over 25 years. The Education Foundation is a 501c3 nonprofit charitable organization formed to support and raise funds for continuing education. Donations are vital to the success of the program. To become involved or to contribute to the Hilton Head Home Builders Education Foundation, contact HBA staff today.
Be part of something great. Join the CBC First Federal Bank family.
a history of strength, and a vision for the future. CBC National Bank and First Federal Bank are coming together to become an even stronger community bank. We're focused on vibrant communities, successful schools, growing businesses, and financial stability. We were voted again by the community as the 2018 Beaufort Gazette Best Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Elite Physical Therapy has enjoyed being your physical therapy provider for the past 10 years. They focus their attention individually with each and every patient, providing a hands-on approach to accelerate your recovery so you can get back to the active lifestyle to which you're accustomed. At Elite Physical Therapy, you'll be treated by the same licensed physical therapist every session to work towards goals you set together. Take control of your health care and choose the best in physical therapy.
And we welcome you into the MVP presentation sponsored by the Charles Sampson Group of Charter One Realty. Great effort tonight by May River. Both Brandon Morales and Ahmad Green got into the end zone twice this evening. But Brandon Morales went over 1,000 yards, and that certainly is worthy and the effort of being tonight's MVP. Congratulations, Brandon. I know Charles Sampson has a little something for you. Charles, please take it away.
Brandon, we've been here now 4 games, and you've done great. But tonight was spectacular, and 1,000 yards. Congratulations, young man.
Congratulations, young man. Very nice playing.
Thank you so much.
Actually, we in honor of you, we'll do something.
We're going to put these. Okay, we're going to put the. I can't believe I'm doing this, but I'm doing it.
Go Sharks.
Go Sharks, absolutely. Brandon, how nice is it running behind that offensive line? They opened up some big holes for you tonight, and you were able to capitalize.
Yes, sir. It was just. I just had to be patient, you know? I know that they're big. They're probably like the biggest O-line, you know, that we have. And I just had to be patient. And I know I congratulate them on everything that I have. Like, I appreciate them. And I would never got to 1,000 yards if it wasn't for them.
Coach, Brandon started as a freshman, took a little step down last year. And is it safe to say he's redeemed himself pretty well this year?
Yeah, he did this summer. You know, he proved to us this summer that he was, you know, committed to the program, and that was a question mark that we had on him. And he's proved that this year, and it's a testament to his hard work, where he's, you know, gotten 1,000 yards now. And he knows he couldn't have done it without Ahmad and the line back there and some other things that worked out well. But, again, it's a great achievement for him, and, you know, we just want to keep moving forward after this and have that windshield mentality and look forward to next week.
You going to keep him busy a little bit more this year?
This guy?
Yeah,
he'll keep running the ball. We may quit trying to throw the ball, you know, every once in a while and just feed it to him.
Coach, congratulations on tonight's victory. Brandon, congratulations on a great bowl series here on WHHI Sports. Good luck moving forward and into the playoffs.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Congratulations, guys.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
That's it for here tonight. Once again, May River wins the Cross County Bowl 30-7. For our production crew, Jeff Shane and Bob Stevens, I'm Chris Tremblay, and
Go
congratulations
Sharks.
To May River. Go Sharks. We'll see you next time right here on WHHI Sports.